I am live streaming and recording. So I have been told that people would like to hear my hear me do the recap. I don't
Wait,
have
not me?
it.
Shane, give us the recap.
If you want, yeah, Shane,
too
go
much
ahead.
happened.
We
Colin should
went
give
on
the
a
recap.
journey,
Yeah, Colin should give the recap.
and
There's a
then
dragon.
we saw Dragon Tales.
All right, so
Dragon
why is
Tales,
this thing
Dragon
crossed out?
Tales.
That's where we already looked, right?
What, the big, the one, the red one at the bottom?
So I was gonna say, do you want me to give the recap or like
It's up to you
It's
guys.
crossed out because it's on fire and
We
currently burning.
nominate Mac.
Oh.
Last time on D&D with the boys.
What's that?
Big boy.
The
All right.
party makes their way to I forget the name of the area. I'm sorry.
Oh,
I don't have a script.
recap.
It is a
Recap.
terrible
More
recap.
like a recrap.
Yeah. It
Oh.
is, yeah.
No, only I do those.
Hashtag skirt, skirt.
All right, who's giving the recap, guys?
Hello?
Zach?
I thought Zach was.
Oh, Zach died again. Oh,
Oh,
wait.
I did?
Zach?
Hello?
No, you're
Yeah,
here.
you cut
Okay.
out, Zach.
I
We weren't
just want.
talking.
I just wanted
You have
to
to
make
start
sure.
over.
All right, so last time on D&D with the boys, the party makes their way to is are still in Thundertree. They end up coming across Spriggans. I don't have it scripted. as luck would have it, Zathira decides to use burning hands and nearly levels the entire forest. The party finds a bunch of dragon cultists. Can I call them that? And Drothgar decides, with no hesitation, I might add, to join the cult. Signed a contract with his blood, and then we decided to take three extra party members with us, NPCs, and find the dragon, take it on. We're here now, and good luck, boys.
Wait, so Trothgar's in a cult now?
Yeah,
Yeah.
you also forgot to
And
mention the fact that him and one of the female cultists shared a very steamy kiss, and she said
very
she'd wait for him.
See,
Oh, no.
this is why I script the recap. I wasn't planning on doing it this week, but
All right, so I'll fill in the blanks. Y'all were
it was
still in
very
Thundertree. Y'all were still in Thundertree. You met a little druid that was living down where Crust keeps putting his token.
Oh, is that the druid?
Yeah, a little druid
Hey,
down
my
there.
boy.
With Brutus the boar.
Brutus the boar, yep. He told you about some giant spiders that you already knew about because they'd almost killed David. Or, sorry, Drothgar. Or, no, it was Carlisle.
It was
Yep.
Carlisle.
That
You
was
guys
fun.
then, while investigating, managed to burn down an entire section of the forest, which was kind of cool. You then, yeah, met with some cultists. Drothgar joined them, you know, like trying to trick them. But also accidentally like put his blood on a on an infernal like contract and sealed his soul to some devilish entity. But he didn't like realize what he was doing, which was kind of awkward. He didn't bother trying to read it. You guys then kind of skipped away from that, having killed the head cultists and recruiting three other ones to hang out with you, one of which was a beautiful elven woman whose picture Colin in the Discord. That elven woman. It says
That's
good
her.
old Mary Lou above her. That's Drothgar's woman.
Okay, right on.
So
Yeah,
Mary
the hot
Lou
thing.
Mary Lou was seduced by Drothgar. They shared a steamy moment, and she said she was fleeing to Neverwinter and she would find him there someday. And then
And
she
Lloyd's dad's gonna be hella mad because he did.
Oh yeah, Lloyd's dad is dead and so is the other guy. But yeah, Lloyd was there because he was take your kid to work day. But anyway, you guys then also met Venomfang, which was a dragon that was living here. Basically, the druid told you there was a dragon, and you were like, "A dragon?" And then you ran up there, and you talked to him and were terrified of him, and managed to escape
The
after
first time?
talking him down. And then you went, "Hey, are we gonna kill this dragon?" And then you went, "Yep." And then you charged back in and started attacking him. And so here we are, with you guys needing to deal with the consequences of getting away and then deciding to fight anyway.
I gave up
decided,
my
no,
amulet for you guys.
we're not going down this way.
So here we are, and
We ain't going out of debt.
Yeah,
we're fighting
we ain't
a
a bunch of
dragon.
pansies.
So I'm trying to decide what music. I think I'm gonna use.
We need the most epic music you have, because this could very well be the last thing we ever do.
Okay,
yeah. We have a bagpipe.
Back.
Yeah.
Imagine fighting a dragon to rip imagine fighting a dragon to rip and tear from Doom.
Yeah, honestly.
Or living on a prayer.
Is this Jump by Van Halen?
I request Jump by Van Halen.
I think we throw on the main theme from Code Vein.
We'll go from.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah.
I'm digging this.
Hello? All right.
Carlisle, you are the first to act after they charge into the room. What do you want to do?
I would like to take out my diamond and and yeet it at the dragon, causing flaming damage.
Oh, this music is crazy.
All right, let's see it.
Oh!
Whoa!
Wah! Oh, okay.
Oh. What? Jeez, I am really lucky that you didn't have advantage.
Yeah.
Blast your diamond forward. What kind of damage are you doing?
That's
a 17.
I said
a 17 just misses.
Ooh! Flaming. I said originally, yeah.
So you launch the diamond forward. It flies through the air, and in this flaming bolt, and the dragon just shoots its wing in front of it and bats it out of the way, and it slams into the rock behind you before the diamond disappears and reappears in your hand. But
the
dragon
misses. Armor class is
17. Misses.
Yep.
The dude's armor class is 18.
Oh boy.
Carlisle, would you like to move?
Run.
I'm just gonna back up one square.
Okay.
One square back. I'm up against the wall.
Drothgar, riding on the back of your valiant steed Crust. What would you like to do?
Well, I'm raging, and I'm great swording.
You're raging? I'm gonna give you a little thing so I remember you're raging. Just like a strong man. Alright.
I'm raging, and I get bonus to hit points or whatever, and I'm gonna.
I gotta turn this down a little bit.
No!
Oh my god! You swing down, and the dragon just like steps back, and you just completely whiff. And the dragon looks down at you and says, "Puny man, you should have run."
Probably.
He
did.
Would you like to demount and run, or are you standing your ground?
Don't.
I'm gonna like. Crust, if we're gonna run, Crust, I want to stay on Crust's back, so I guess I'll stay with him for now.
All right, Zathira.
That's me.
That's me.
I'm still trying to think about what spell I want to cast at this oaf. So I think
that's beautiful.
I think my best bet.
Thanks, Colin.
Honestly, so I'm gonna move here, so I have better line of sight, and I'm gonna cast Magic Missile, but I'm gonna cast it as a that's not what I wanted to do.
As a second level spell?
Yeah.
Did you get another one?
Oh, so I just cast it four times instead of the three.
Yeah.
There we go.
Oh wow!
And then we transition into
Yoshi's story.
Moment.
Oh. We transition.
Do you have any like Star Wars music? Like,
actually, I don't have Duel of Fates.
That's okay.
But I do have the second best thing.
I think I know. Bum, bum, bum,
bum. I just have to find it. Yeah. Alright, you guys. Do you want Star Wars music?
Yes, sir.
The Cantina music.
Here we go. No, it is, in fact, the one and the only. Battle of Heroes, the
from episode three.
The song that plays from episode three when yes. Anakin and Obi-Wan are fighting.
Yes.
Oh, dude, that's epic. I have the high ground.
You were said to bring balance to the Force. Not destroy it.
Go ahead.
All right, Zathira, you did 6, 7, 8.
13?
Yeah, 13 points of damage, and magic missiles always hit.
Yeah.
You underestimate my power.
I'm just going to go, hang on. Oh, just ignore that.
Sand.
Ignore that. You said his attack will hit up to here, right? Like, so basically
You don't know that. You have no idea.
Oh, okay. Well, in that case, I'm just going to... I'll move over here.
All right. Crust. Crust, you are up.
I shall bite and claw.
Whip and tear.
And run away.
Yeah.
A 13 does not
oh,
hit.
Wow.
A 16 does not
oh,
hit.
Oh, whoa!
We're running.
I'm going
to take a free swing.
I'm sweating, guys. Oh.
You're going to take the free swing against...
No!
Drop car.
No!
Everyone
just a fat guy. I'm already on his back.
That is a 12 to hit Drothgar.
No, Colin, you're supposed to move back more.
It snaps out and bites down at the
bad.
Air just behind you. You feel a breeze behind you, Drothgar. You can't move that far because you can't move onto the Zathira.
Oh no, I'm
you
sorry.
Feel yeah. You feel a breeze as the teeth almost clamp down on you, Drothgar.
You hear Carlisle from the back. I have a bad feeling about this.
Yeah.
Drothgar, you should ride on the Crust's head, not his back.
All right.
He's in my mouth.
Yeah, right. You're protecting him in your jaws.
All right, stop moving yourself. All right, Yoshi, you're
I
up.
Move myself.
All right, you know what it is. Pull up my longbow.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, boy.
Yo!
Oh! The arrow
sinks
into his neck, and it recoils in pain and crunches the stones beneath his claws,
oh,
looking at you with
boy.
Pure rage. Would you like to move?
Yeah, I'll roll back.
Sorry, guys, I'm getting a phone call. Just give me one sec. I'll leave you on, though, so you can hear.
Yeah.
Okay. Hi, babe.
Hello?
Baby?
Can I just point out that maybe Crust should have stayed in the room, because now the dragon can move forward and breathe and develop this entire room?
Yeah.
That's true.
It is now Venom Fang's turn.
We are, yeah, we've made a terrible mistake.
Venom Fang jumps down.
Yeah.
Lands in the doorway.
I see it. Oh, I knew it. We're
dead. Inhales and blasts this massive cloud of noxious gas.
Yeah, that's where we die, guys. Good game. Yeah, good game.
Hold on. We don't know that. Hold on.
I need you all to make constitution savings.
I just that's click it, core.
Yep, just click constitution save.
On saving throw.
Let's go, baby.
Oh,
where's
guys?
Your booty's gone.
My booty's gone, guys. I'm dead.
Well, hold on.
What?
All right.
What?
It
Carlisle.
Yes, sir.
Crust, Yoshi, and Drothgar. Well, actually, sorry, not Drothgar.
Oh.
Carlisle. Carlisle. Crust.
Well,
and Yoshi. You guys take 22 points.
What?
Yo!
Yo, I'm dead.
I'm down to one.
Crest,
I'm
you.
Dead.
Crest, I knocked off your health as a bear. You're down to 12 health as a bear.
Thank you.
Wait, it's time to run, boys.
Yoshi, did you not have full health?
Wait, okay, so. Because I was at 20 health when at the start of this game.
Right, but because remember you kept rolling in and out when he said not to, and then he clawed you last game.
Right, I'm dead.
So you're not dead, you're unconscious.
Okay, I'm unconscious.
All right.
I'm not done yet.
Zathira. I'm really worried about what's about to happen to you, Zathira. How much health do you have?
I got 20.
I think this might insta-kill you.
Oh my gosh.
No.
My cheeks.
Is this Thera?
Thera, you take 40 points.
Yo!
You take 38 points of damage.
That's, wow.
Yeah, you are, you know, I just checked your health, you're okay. You're not instantly dead.
So our
but you are very close.
Our adventure tonight just turned into a character creation module.
Literally.
Drothgar, you take 11 points of poison damage.
Yo,
because,
okay.
Because you made the save and you're raging, so it double halves, so you're down to only 11 points of damage.
Duh.
All right, Carlisle, you're up. What would you like to do?
I shakily take out my chromatic orb, and I'm like, please hit. Please hit. And I would like to do thunder damage.
See it.
Thunderclap.
Oh my gosh.
You throw the diamond, and it, boom, flashes from your hand as if at the speed of light. There's a thunderous crack as it slams into the wall behind the dragon and again reappears in your hand, unable.
Okay.
To hit.
I would like to. Oh boy.
Break down the door.
Disengage.
Is the door at the bottom open?
They're both open.
Okay. I would like to bonus action dash out the door.
You haven't even used your move.
Sorry, yeah, I'd like to run out the door, so...
If you bonus action, so you can get to either here, or if you'd like to bonus action dash, you can get, like, way down here.
I would like to get way down there.
Alright, Carlisle just dips.
Carlisle's just like, I know where this is going, and I don't like it, I'm sorry!
Drothgar, you
can
are...
Can I be the last man standing perk in this
game? Can I disengage?
Sure, but it takes half your movement to get off of...
Oh shoot! Seriously?
It takes 15, like half of your movement to get off of to dismount.
Really?
Yeah.
So I trust that Cross can just leave on behalf of both of us.
Okay. Are you gonna do anything? Do you wanna do something else with your action?
In the meantime,
do you have any ranged attacks?
In the meantime, I'm gonna have to use a javelin.
Yeah.
All right. Go ahead. Throw that javelin.
Hoping that Crest. runs away.
Maybe picks us up too, you know, it'd be nice.
Oh! You throw the javelin and it just clatters against the wall. It's just in panic. Zathira, I need you to make it. Actually, wait, I need to do something to your character sheet.
A death save?
Yeah, but I'm setting up your character sheet so that your death saves are only whispered to me. Whisper rolls to GM.
I like that. I like that a lot.
Always whisper. Oh no!
No!
I love this.
I'm just trying to find where it is.
I've heard about between Craig and I. I've heard about this thing, and it's great. I love it. I want to try it.
I'm just trying to find where it says to whisper. Death saves. Death saving throw modifier. Sorry, guys. I just want to find.
Okay.
Look it up.
I just have to look on the character sheet until I find it.
Colin.
Okay, I can't find it, so you're just gonna have to roll it. Alright, go ahead and click the death save. Let's see it. Whoa!
Oh! Oh!
He's alive! He's alive!
Not only are you alive, Zathira, you open your eyes. You are awake with one hit point. You just sort of, you wake up. You just, huh, and you're awake.
Yo!
That's at the start of your turn, so you can take your turn still, if you'd like to do something.
Can I pick up Yoshi and run?
Yeah, pick me up.
It'll take
pull me out. Just pull me out.
So you can get to about.
Or can
here.
Can I attack first and then do it?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. Okay.
Pull me out.
If I move one square forward and then pick him up, would I still be able to go like about there?
You were here, right? So you go five. Now you're.
Well, so no, if I move to right here from
you
there,
you started here though. Is what I'm saying. Yeah. So you started here. So you're gonna move here.
If that was the that's 5 feet.
Then you can move.
Is that I can hit him yeah. with that. Yeah. Okay.
Yep.
Then I'm gonna cast Burning Hands as a second level.
All right. He's gonna make a Dexterity saving throw.
Where is it? Where's Burning Hands? There it is. Here we go. Second level.
Your DC is 13. He fails, so he's going to take 21 yeah. points of damage.
Knock me. Suck it.
I'm alive.
And now I'm going to take Yoshi and run.
Yeah, roll me out, please.
All right.
What's that?
Just something I had to do some math. All right. And then you're moving out here, so you get to yeah. there. Okay, Crust, you are up. What you like to do?
I would like to bite and claw.
So you're gonna move up and bite and claw?
Yeah.
All right. You
oh my!
With Drothgar on your back, and
he
you should bite
ran
and
when he had the chance.
Let's see it. Bite and claw. Well, that hits.
Come on, one more. Do it.
That does not hit.
Oh. Does it matter that I did bite twice by accident?
Oh, it does. Yeah, you have to hit claw, hit claw.
Oh!
All right. Click damage on the bite and then on that specific claw one as well, because it'll do all the extra damage.
Oh my god.
Oh my goodness.
See, now everybody's thinking. Big. See, now everybody's thinking, like, we can actually do this.
Maybe I want to see now. I want to fight.
Carlisle is gone. Carlisle,
yeah, I'm waiting for you guys. Just like I'm waiting for you guys. Like, come on, like follow my lead, guys. Let's go.
This is great.
That is 29 points of damage.
Wow.
As you bite into it. Okay, so you bite into his leg and you pull out just this string of tendons and he falls down, and as he's falling you take the claw and you just ram it into the side of his head and tear across. Oh. He roars in pain. He is in extreme pain, and you look at him, he looks panicked all of a sudden.
Ooh.
Yoshi, I need you to make
I'm gonna
a death saving throw.
Oh dang it, okay.
I'm gonna revive myself. It's not.
I'm gonna revive myself, and I'm gonna go in and roll right up to him.
Well, make a death saving throw.
What's that again?
It's so on your core sheet. Yeah, right underneath your health, you see like the six little circles. It says success and failures. Right underneath failures, it says death saves.
You click on that word.
I'll
yeah.
click on my character first.
No, you don't have to.
You don't have to.
Oh no.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's on your character sheet.
Yoshi also opens his eyes and wakes up, Yoshi, with 1 hit point. Yoshi, you have
one hit point,
and your eyes, boing, spring open. It's the start of your turn. What do you want to do, roll away or roll back in?
Can I shoot him from here?
No, there's a wall.
No, there's a wall.
Wait,
question.
You have to roll through the door.
Hang on. If this is an arrow slot,
it's
can
up,
he shoot through
it's
there?
It's up higher in the wall, so he has no line of sight.
Wait, can I roll in and shoot, then roll back out?
You have that. Well, I have to check. So you're here. So that's 15 and 15. You can. Yeah.
Oh shoot! All right. So I roll in. Like I'll be like, yo, I'm alive, suckers.
This dragon boy.
Yeah. And then suck on this lombo straight to the guy's face.
Let's see it.
Roll another
boom,
nat
20.
Boom.
Oh.
Wow!
And then I roll out.
You roll in, you shoot him in the face. Big wheels. He actually looks really worried.
Oh, shoot.
What's wrong, Daddy?
And then he looks at you for a second.
What's wrong?
Looks back.
What's wrong, Daddy?
Venom Fang is going to... Well, he's gonna roll to see if he gets his breath weapon back. He does not.
Ooh.
Oh.
He can suck a fat one with his breath weapon.
He's gonna make his multi-attack. He makes one bite and two claws. He's gonna make one bite against Drothgar, one claw against Drothgar, and one claw against Crust.
Drothgar.
Drothgar.
So, wow. Drothgar, bite against you. 20 to hit.
Yeah.
You take 19 halved to, because you're raging, so it's halved, so 9. You take 8. 9 points of damage.
9, yeah.
9. Then the claw, natural one, he swings right over your head. As you, so you get bit into, he pulls back, he goes to claw at you, and you press yourself into Crust. He takes his claw, he rears back, and goes to stab Crust with his claw. Natural 20.
It doesn't Crust.
Crust, you take... Wow, you're lucky. So you only take 10 points of damage. Crust, your bear form... That was a really bad crit. Your bear form still has 2 hit points.
Loser, and double loser.
He's going to turn around... and fly up.
That's cheating.
Fly up out of the building. He has what fly speed? 80 feet. So he flies up the 30 feet. And then he flies all the way over here. You guys see him fly away, but Crust and Drothgar, you guys get a free attack against him.
Ooh.
Just one.
I can't multitask again?
No, okay. Just one.
Can I not greatsword him when he's leaving?
You can, yeah. Crest and Drothgar, you get a free attack.
Also, me and Yoshi are still well within range, too.
Let's see it.
Oh, come on!
Come on.
Go ahead, Crest, you hit. Hit that attack, hit that damage.
You're gonna see
something. Oh, man!
You're gonna see something really... Him? Hold on, there you go.
Did I get him?
Ignore it.
You did get him. You hit him for 14 damage. He claws, he flies, and you can see as he's flying, he's like bleeding profusely, and he's just desperately trying to fly away. Carlisle, Carlisle, you stopped at the bottom of the hill.
Mm-hmm.
You look up, you see your friends piling out, and then you see but you don't see Crust, and you don't see Drothgar, and then you see a bloody dragon flying away, looking like he's lopsided, like in pain. He looks rough.
Yeah.
I
would like to it's going to be a really stupid question. What would the range on my crossbow be?
You don't have it in there? It should be on your sheet.
Yeah.
Oh, I accidentally left the server. Give me a second.
Go closer to
your orb is like 90 feet though.
He's out of spell slots.
Yeah, I have no spell slots right now. I have a spell that I could use, but I'm wondering if
check. It should be on your sheet.
It looks like
hand crossbow 30, 120.
120. So
30 feet normal, and then 120 feet at disadvantage.
Okay, so let's say I run 30 feet. Sorry guys, I don't mean to take up so much time.
No, you take your time, man. You have some thinking to do.
So let's say I run up to here 30 feet, and I...
Bonus action dash?
Well, no, I'm trying to figure out how far the dragon is right now. It's 35 feet, so...
The angle doesn't matter. Don't think of directions, because it's non-Euclidean. So it's just whatever line's longest. So right now he's 35 feet.
Yeah, yeah. So I would like to... cast Toll of the Dead on the dragon.
Ooh. All right, he's gonna make his Wisdom saving throw.
Oh, and it does more damage because he's hurt, right?
Yeah.
It's Wisdom saving throw, correct?
Yes.
What's your DC?
12.
Oh, that's a 7. So you do. He does the full damage.
Does like a whole 5 hit points.
Wait, hit the bell.
You hear, you see the dragon, like, squint. He's still flying away, though. Drothgar. You can't see him from where you are. He's flown up and out of the tower.
If Drothgar moves to this, can he javelin out of it, or is that still too high?
No. That thing only goes up, like, 12 feet. The tower's 30 feet up. He's out of your vision, Drothgar.
I'm dismounting, so it's going to take 15, right?
You can dismount.
I wanted to dismount over here.
Oh, okay.
Because can I javelin him from an angle over here?
You can try.
Isn't that a door there?
Yeah, it's a door.
Yeah,
so
he can walk out.
You want to like move up here,
get
sort of.
15.
Yep. So that's.
So can I...
What's the range on your javelins?
Let me check.
It is 30, 120, same as a hand crossbow. So
nice.
It's at disadvantage, but you can do it.
It's the only thing I really can do.
Take the throw.
Oh,
yeah. Oh my gosh.
That's it's okay.
You haven't rolled like over a five. You fall back, with my roll, man. You throw it, it arcs, and it just falls short, unable to hit him as he's flying. Also,
I am
pretty
hurt.
Oh, no, you were hit last turn, so you're still raging. All right, Zathira, one hit point. The dragon's flying away. What do you want to do?
Say one hit point? Oh, me, yeah.
You're
okay.
Up.
1d10, or that does 3. I am going to move right here.
Okay.
I am well within range, and I'm going to cast my 3 magic missiles on him.
Go for it.
Pew, pew, pew.
Pooh. Ah, pow. Nice.
Holds his hand out like a finger gun. Pew,
pew, pew. That's 10 damage.
Yep.
That's a lot of damage.
He's not looking good. Like, this guy, the second he gets a chance, he's gone. He is flying away. Like, he is running. As your magic missiles arc through the air and slam into him, he falls like 20 feet and then flaps back up as he's just barely clinging on.
You better
rest. It's your turn. You cannot see him right now.
I'm just gonna run out this door here.
The top one, like, or the bottom?
The top one.
Okay. So that's
and
15.
Then how many steps was that?
15.
Okay, and then I'll just move another 15. This way.
Okay.
I'm hunting him down.
Okay. He's flying.
Yoshi, you got a good hit.
I know you have spells and stuff. I don't know if you want to, like, untransfer.
How far is he from... Where's this?
What, like 35?
From
he's
you,
like 30
he's
feet,
45 feet. Yeah.
No, not even. He's 40 feet.
Hold on then. Let me... Spells.
Guys, the turn's tabled real quick.
that crit from Crust.
Oops,
was...
I didn't mean to do that.
Okay.
It's 90 feet though.
Yeah, but that's on the ground.
Yeah, he's in the air.
Or from the ground.
Oh.
15 cube. I don't really have anything I can.
Yeah, do you want me to just take a look and
heat just metal? Case?
Heat metal.
Does he have any metal on him?
You might be able to cast fairy. Do you have fairy fire prepared? Oh no, you don't.
No, I don't.
You could heal Drothgar.
I want to cast speak with animal and tell him to suck it.
he speaks common.
He's a dragon. He speaks common. You can turn.
Honestly, yeah. I'll just transform into my cute little self, and
full health. Ba-doop. Hello.
I'll cast healing word on Drothgar.
Baby. Never mind the two other people.
I'm gonna cast heat metal on. Right.
You cast heat
metal
on
Drothgar.
What's all right, Drothgar, you heal up 6 hit points. What is your healing word?
The gamer word.
We established that like the first game.
All right, moving on. Yoshi.
Want to eat the real food?
Yoshi.
Yoshi is flying away.
I'm gonna roll up right here. And then we're from my Lambo.
We got a regular firing squad going on here.
From my Lambo, and as soon as I shoot him, be like, "What's wrong, Daddy?"
Oh no!
Can I give him advantage?
No.
I help him with the bow.
Straighten up his arms a little. You boom! It shoots through the air. It arcs, and it looks like it's just gonna hit him, and it falls just short.
What?
Not hitting him with a 17.
Yeah.
That's dumb.
We established that earlier. That's why everybody said no.
Alright.
It is Venom Fang's turn. Venom Fang is going to roll to see if he gets his breath weapon. He does not. He is going to fly. He's going to dash. Fly.
Then we all get a free hit, right?
No. Yeah. 160 feet just whoosh, gone. Venom
wow,
Fang is
what
gone.
A jerk.
He has escaped.
What a jerk.
But you guys are
out of combat.
Nah, that's pretty stupid.
In that case, I move in here and inspect the loot.
Yo, wait for me!
Where's the loot at?
Where's the loot at?
In his home.
Yeah, but long rest in his house.
Guys, you just chased away a dragon.
Yeah, we did.
Sure, show that dragon who's boss, man. That was quite the roller coaster of emotions.
You guys realize, like, if I had made a couple hits, he might have been dead.
Yeah, if Drothgar actually knew how to use his greatsword.
If I hit him with that initial chromatic orb. That would have. Oh,
Craig, just so it hurts us even more, how much health did he have left?
He had 22 hit points.
Oh.
So even if Yoshi's longbow hit.
Yeah.
Oh well, we tried. Yeah. We tried. Good job,
boys. Basically, yeah. If your chromatic orb hit in the beginning and Drothgar actually landed an attack.
All right. You so that dragon. You guys run in. And you're like, let's see all the goods that we get. So yes, a few please. Things. You get your pendant back. Carlisle.
Yeah, I do.
Grab that right away.
I'm gonna.
You guys find 800 silver pieces.
What?
There's five of you, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So you each get 160 silver.
I take it all for myself.
Doesn't even give Crust the option.
I only do that when I find it myself.
You find 150 gold, which means you each get 30 gold.
Oh, I goofed.
Wow.
Hold on.
This is all anticlimactic.
So everybody gets 160 silver, 30
you
gold.
You see piles of gold. Yeah, he's got 150 gold.
Are you going to let me finish? 150 gold is a lot of money. Thank you very much.
100.
And 800 silver.
Only
can you imagine a pile of 800, like, loonies? That's crazy. That's a lot of loonies. All right. 160, so everybody add 160 silver and 30 gold. Has everybody done that, or am I going to have to repeat it again?
How much silver?
160.
And how much gold?
30.
It's on page 121, right?
Of course.
Shane, do you have it written down?
Yeah, I got it.
Craig's just like, and then the dragon swoops back in.
Yeah, it kills everyone.
You find four silver goblets set with moonstones. Ooh. Each of these goblets, you figure, are worth 60 gold. Hmm. So you can put those. Somebody can put that in their inventory to sell later.
Who wants to take it? Not Crust.
I'll take it.
Listen. And then when you sell it, divide evenly.
Of course. The person who ran away hold all the money. Cool.
You find two scrolls.
Scrolls.
A scroll of Misty Step, which is basically a bonus action teleport.
That's what Glass Staff did, didn't he?
Glass Staff did, yep. So a scroll of Misty Step and a scroll of Lightning Bolt, which is a very powerful spell.
Can I take them? Do you guys object?
No.
Take them.
Let the wizard have it.
And you also... He's a sorcerer. Find something that's very interesting. It looks like a rusty old battle axe made by dwarves. There's runes in dwarvish on the axe head. And for those of you that read can speak Dwarven, so Drothgar and
me,
the word says hew on the side, like H-E-W, like if you hew a tree or something, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So,
Craig, it appears to... Sorry?
No, go ahead.
The runes appear to glow slightly.
I'm taking
can
it.
Can I inspect it?
You want to make sure? Make an Arcana check.
You're damn right I'm going to make an Arcana check.
Yeah. This is a magical battle axe. It is a +1 battle axe that automatically deals maximum damage if you hit a plant creature or an object made of wood.
Oh. Ooh.
Craig, sorry, really quick. How many goblets were there and how much were they worth?
460 each.
Okay. Thank you.
60
gold?
60 gold, yeah.
60 gold each. So do you want to take Hugh, Drothgar?
I do.
Hugh, right. Betcha!
Is Hugh better than my regular hand axe?
Well, your hand axe? Yeah, you just can't throw Hugh. Hand axes you can throw. So I'm going to change his name here to...
Hugh Betcha.
Our battle axes...
You should rename it to Hugh Hefner.
So it's... Oh, yeah, yeah. No, a battle axe is versatile.
It's two-handed, though, right? So it's like his greatsword?
This isn't a Kratos situation where you can take your axe, throw it, and it returns to your hand.
No, there is a magic item for that, though.
Yeah, there is.
Oh, this is not set up nicely. Give me one second. I'm going to fix it on your screen.
Guys, we scared a dragon off. Like, can you imagine?
Yeah, this guy's going to come... this guy's going to
go foo. That's it.
Yeah, this guy's going to come home, and he's going to be like, my loot.
If he dares to come home...
I was going to say
What was he going to say?
You cut out.
What?
You cut out. You said I was going to say and then cut out.
Craig mentioned that we could have been level 4 if we won, right?
Yeah, last week he said that, but we didn't. But we didn't kill it.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. So Drothgar or David.
Yeah.
So Hugh is considered a magical weapon, which your greatsword isn't, so it can bypass certain resistances from magical creatures. But also, you can either swing it one-handed or two-handed. One-handed, it does 1d8 damage. Two-handed, it does 1d10. And all the damage has a 1 on top of it. So you can give it a couple swings, but it's in your shoe there.
I don't know what 1d10 or 1d8
it's
means.
It's one dice that's 10-sided, or one dice that's 8-sided.
Sorry, I'm just fixing it.
Oh. So, 1d10 is you roll a 10-sided die.
David, stop.
Oh, sorry.
All right, now you're good. See, that's two hand.
Oh, sorry.
You're just going to click that a bunch, aren't you?
Dude, you're gonna waste all of your good rolls.
But there you go. You guys have driven away.
So, are you able to send me, the bio? How can I have the, how can I have the Scroll of Lightning as, a clickable thing? So if I click it, it'll just,
do Lightning Bolt? You can. Just put Scroll of Lightning Bolt, and then if you want to use it, I will.
I noticed, okay. And then Scroll of Misty Step is...
Same thing.
It's a bonus action?
Yeah.
Bonus action. How many feet can I use it for?
30 feet.
30 feet. Yeah. So I'm writing it in its description so I know.
Yep. Lightning bolt is a straight line. It's lots of pain. Ooh.
So I forgot I had the scroll of augury. I wonder if I used it, if it would have said attacking the dragon was a good or bad idea.
All right. What do you guys want to do? You guys go off the dragon?
Do we want to go see the other guy, or do we want a long rest and then...
I would like
him?
To long... You do see Carlisle these... just shoot his hand up in the air. I would like to long rest.
Long rest in the dragon's lair?
I am fatally injured.
Do these stairs lead anywhere, or are they just crumbled?
They just crumbled. They lead up... That's where the horde was, on the top of the
okay.
stairs.
You guys just want to full on balls of steel long rest in this dude's lair.
You guys also know that the druid did offer that you could stay in his place. Like he did tell you guys that.
If you'd rather have him there.
Yeah, let's go there. Let's go there. Let's go see the druid again.
Go have some tea and then sleep forever.
I say Crust leads the way as he's the only person here with full health.
Drag me, please.
Drag me.
You guys take your time, but eventually... Oh, I guess you're not ranging any. You guys take... Clicking things. You guys make your way... You guys don't have to, go step by step. Just drag yourself to the druid. You guys walk through the woods, and you bloodily and in horrible pain stumble into the front door The man pokes his head out and says,
except for Carlisle. Carlisle apparently like went to the back of the forest.
I'm sorry,
for some
I have to place then scroll because for my
just
live
zoom
stream,
out.
What, I didn't
yeah,
want to do that.
That. Top right of the map.
Oh, and I know how to do it, but I didn't want to do it.
He chose not to.
You see the druid kind of, well, you guys aren't close yet, but he kind of opens the door and he looks, he says, you went and fought the dragon, didn't you?
What gave it away?
The profuse bleeding.
Oh, right.
What is this? Yeah,
we did.
We managed to almost kill it, but we definitely drove it off.
We bloodied
really?
It. Yes.
Oh. Yeah, it was a battle for the sentry, that's for sure. It was hit or miss.
As a reward, I will allow you to sleep in my home if you can remember my name.
I know it. Hang
Daddy.
On.
Daddy.
Hang on.
Druid.
Radoff.
That's it! And he lets you in. He says, yeah, have some tea. And he gets
I wanna have...
And Brutus. Radoff and Brutus.
Thank I want to have druid talks with him.
Sure. He says, what's up, fellow kids? He says, are you a druid too?
No.
Ah! Oh.
Yeah, that was a joke.
Oh, yeah? What can you turn into?
Ape, axe beak, baboon, badger, black bear, boar, brown bear, cat, camel, deer, dire wolf, draft horse, elk, giant badger, giant centipede, giant fire beetle,
what?
Giant goat, giant hyena, giant lizard, giant rat, giant weasel, giant wolf spider, goat, hyena, jackal, lion, lizard, mule, panther, pony, rat, riding horse, scorpion, spider, tiger,
oh
warhorse, weasel. What about you?
He says, some of those things, but not all of them.
And yet he keeps changing into a bear!
The bear is really strong.
I had no idea.
Wow.
My bad, I'll turn into a rat next time.
Yeah, next time we fight a dragon, please turn into a rat.
Yeah, the brown bear is very, very good.
Remember
oh,
when you
that
wanted
hurt.
To turn into a camel?
I still want to, very badly.
My favorite is when you're going through like giant badger, giant centipede, giant fire beetle, giant goat, giant hyena, like just all the giant things.
There's so many giants.
Tiger.
Can I play my bagpipes?
Yeah, of course. Make a performance check.
Yeah, make sure it's good.
Or a bagpipes check, I guess.
So how did... I want a boar like Brutus. How did you get it?
Oh, Brutus and I met a long time ago, and we just worked together, and here we are.
Did you ever turn into a boar and keep each other company?
He kind of looks at you for a minute, make a persuasion check. Your bagpipe playing is nice. Not great.
It's
make
deep.
A performance check for me.
Oh, performance?
Sorry, persuasion. He looks at you for a second, and he leans over and whispers into your ear, and he says, only on the last Tuesday.
This guy's weird. We gotta leave.
Oh, dear.
Ask him who's the top and who's the bottom.
I don't want to know.
you guys take your time and you lie down and you take your long rest. Everybody, you can put all your spell slots back up to full. All your health
gosh.
Back up to full. And once you have put all your spell slots...
Can I prepare new spells since I didn't this time?
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
You prepare the spells at a long rest, not at the beginning of the session.
Oh, okay. Is this long rest?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
That's why he said you take your long rest.
Before you do that, everybody mark your health to full and your spell slots to full.
Mm-hmm.
And now, mark that you're level 4.
Oh!
Boy, baby!
We did it, guys! We're level
How many spells
four.
Do I get now?
okay, well...
There it is.
We'll go through one by one, so...
Oh, shoot, so I get 11 health every time, right?
Before you do anything else, please do your health. Your health.
Yes, sir.
If I forget... what my thing was.
Were you rolling for it, or were you doing the
average? No, mine was the average.
So you're doing, so you have 4 plus your constitution modifier.
Ooh, so I get 6.
So...
Wait, 4 plus constitution?
Not you, not you, David. David, you get 7 plus your constitution modifier.
What's my constitution modifier?
Well, look at constitution.
It's
and
the big number in constitution.
Oh, 2.
Big as in sun.
For rolling, for people who are rolling their health.
Yeah, just click your hit die button. Just roll once. There you go, 7 more health.
Yay. I get an even 30 hit points.
As a druid, you get 5 plus your hit die, or plus your constitution modifier.
3.
And,
no, I lied.
Shane, you get 6 plus your constitution modifier.
Man, I can't get over the fact that both me and Shane went down and then rolled nat 20 to get back up.
No.
Trust your con modifier is 3.
Yeah, I'm a beefy lad now.
Yoshi, your con modifier is 1. So did you added that as well?
Yoshi? Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Everybody has done their health, correct?
Yes.
Okay, so we are on level 4. So something. So at the top of your character sheet, please, everybody, make sure you mark that you are now level 4. I see Yoshi's already done it. Crust, you are doing it, I believe. Drothgar, you just did it. Good. Make sure you close it up when you're done. Hit the gear again. Carlisle, you got it done.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You are level 4, which means we get to get weird. Okay.
We haven't been already.
So on the left-hand side of your screen, you see all your ability scores, right? Your strength, dex, constitution, everything like that.
Yes.
Yeah.
You get to add, you know, the tiny number that's bigger in value, but it's tiny.
Yeah.
You get to add 2 to either one of those, or 1 to 2 of them. Okay.
Mm-hmm. What do I want as a druid?
Now, let me finish. I'm not done yet. So, just so you guys know, even numbers is when your stats increase. Okay? So, for example, a great thing for Yoshi to do, if Yoshi takes 1 in his dex, he'll be at 18 dex, which means all of his dexterity-based attack rolls and damage will go up. Okay? If you're going from an odd number to an even number, or from, like, an even number plus 2 to another even number, you're going to get an addition to your modifier. Okay? Does that make sense?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, the other thing you can do, just to make this even more complex, is you can get a foot. And by foot, I mean feet. You can get a feet. So, if you go to page 166 in the PDF of
Player's Craig.
Yep.
Somebody named Main Laynards says, "Tell Craig, Main Laynards loves him, and to give you inspiration."
Oh no, you don't get inspiration. Listen here, Manly Nerds. That's Greg. Dang it, Greg!
That's Greg. It's Manly Nerds. It's M-A-I-N-E.
Mainly Nerds. Yeah.
Mainly Nerds.
It doesn't say Nerds at the end.
Yeah.
Yeah, because he's from Maine. His name is Greg. He's a good guy.
Well, Greg just missed us fight the dragon, so.
Hello, Greg.
Greg.
Well, I published the, if he missed the fight, I published my videos on YouTube.
There you go, Greg. Don't worry, Greg.
What page did you tell us to turn to?
Greg posts his channel all the time in all of my Discord chats, so you're allowed to plug whatever you want.
Fantastic. YouTube.com/CaptainNubify.
Okay, there you go. If you guys turn in your Bibles, turn in your Player's Handbook to page 166, the PDF, you will see there's a section that's called Feats. There are a lot of them. Instead of taking your plus 2 to 1 stat or your plus 1 to 2 stats, you could take a feat.
Oh my gosh.
There's a massive list, and they all do weird and wonderful things. A great example of one is called Tough. It just gives you a butt ton of health, and you get more health every time you level up. There's another one that's called Magic Initiate, which lets you cast spells if you normally can't. There's another one called Mounted Combatant, which makes you really good when you're riding stuff.
What page is this on again?
166.
Dang it, Shane. I said it 7 times.
I know, I forgot.
You need to say it 166 times.
All right. Jeez. Oh, I got a hurt from Greg in Discord. Anyway, okay, holy smokes. Yeah, so you can, there's a massive list. There's like Defensive Duelist, Dual Wielder, Grappler, Keen Mind, Great Weapon Master. There's so many. If you want to pick a feat, you can.
Oh gosh.
If you would rather just buff your stats, that is also a very good choice. Some of the best feats that I really like, Sharpshooter is a really good feat if you're somebody that shoots a lot at range. It means that you don't get disadvantage up to the max range, so that means Yoshi can like shoot like 600 feet without disadvantage. Plus, you can take a subtraction to hit, and it lets you add 10 damage if you do hit. So it's like a high risk, high reward thing.
The crossbow expert.
Crossbow expert's different. Crossbow expert lets you shoot a bunch of times with a crossbow when you normally can.
I have a question, Greg.
Yeah.
Warcaster, would that allow me to cast when I'm in my wild shape?
No. So. The way that your wild shape works is you can if you cast a concentration spell and then morph, you can hold concentration. What Warcast would do would give you advantage on saving throws to maintain that concentration.
So I could do like heat metal and then turn into my bear?
Correct. You can already do that though. Warcaster would just give you advantage on those checks when you get hit to keep the concentration up. It's a good spell if you are a caster that finds yourself in combat a lot. If you're casting a lot of concentration spells, it's very, very useful. Also, it lets you cast spells as an opportunity attack. So when things are trying to run away from you, you know how you get a free hit?
Mm-hmm.
Well, instead of a free hit, you can cast a spell instead, which is really
cool.
It's still not your animal form. That is actually a feature of a druid that you get later.
One of my favorite feats is Tavern Brawler.
Yep, Tavern Brawler is really cool.
Yeah, essentially you can pick up a chair and like over somebody's head with it.
Yeah, it makes you proficient with improvised weapons, so like you're just really good at fighting with whatever you have. just like grab a cask.
As a D&D noob, would it be better for me to grab a feat as a sorcerer?
Honestly, it is totally up to you. I like usually for my first, because you get a few of these, okay? This isn't the only time. At 4, 8, 12, 16, all of those, you get these. Let me double check. Fighter, I think Shane gets them even more often. Yeah, Shane gets them every other level as a fighter. But like everybody else gets them every 4 levels. What I like to do with my first one is just get stats. I like to bump my stats up because stats are really good. Stats just help you. Later on, I'll take feats. But like you as a sorcerer, Zathira, if you look at your stats, your charisma is 17.
Yeah, that's what I was looking at because my spells are based off of charisma, aren't they? Because
correct.
As a sorcerer.
So a really good thing that if I was you, this is just me. I would put 1 point in charisma and 1 point in constitution, because then
I get those both up.
And you get more health, because if your constitution goes up, you get more health. You get one more health for every level that you. So if you end up in constitution, you just get to increase your health by 4.
So I'm gonna take 2.
So
don't interrupt. Don't interrupt.
Sorry. You go ahead, Zach.
So I'm gonna take an ability point in strength and an ability point in dexterity.
Nice.
Yeah, just because I'm tired of not hitting stuff.
And this is where people differ. See, if I was Zach, I would take 1 in dexterity and 1 in intelligence because that raises my spell DC. because your spells are based on intelligence, so that lets your chromatic orbs hit easier, and your Toll the Dead is harder to dodge and stuff.
You said one in strength and one in...
No, not strength. One in dex and one in intelligence, because you had a 9 in strength, right?
Yeah, I did.
Who cares about strength? You're a rogue. That crap. Because then you'd have a 14 dex, so now your pew-pew boys hit better, and then you'd have a 16 intelligence, which means your magic is stronger, too.
All
right. That's just me.
No,
I don't want to tell you guys what to do.
That sounds fantastic. I'm gonna do it.
Also, I meant to say this earlier, Zach, but Mainly Nerds wants your YouTube channel to look it up. So if you want to hop into my stream, you can.
Oh, I just said it's youtube.com/CaptainNubify.
Yeah, but he said send it to him. That's why.
I will just send it, Greg.
C A P T A I N O O B I F Y. All one word.
Got you in my sights. No, I've got Discord, so I'll just...
If I upped my constitution now, would that extra health take effect now or next level?
Yeah. No, right now. Oh. You just get 4 more health.
Then, boy, you know what your boy is doing. We're going...
Make sure you change your constitution to 16.
Charisma and constitution to 16.
Boom, all of a sudden you have 30 hit points.
Beefy boy!
Don't forget your max hit points goes up as well.
Yeah.
All right, so...
I want to take Lucky.
I knew someone would find it. Lucky is a special feat that I love. DMs everywhere will disallow it because it's kind of absurd. But Lucky is a feat to pick. It is.
How do I implement that into my character sheet?
So what you do is... under, I'll help you out.
Yo, okay, never mind. I made my choice. I'm sticking with it. Nope.
So under, see where you have features and traits, and you've got all of your savage critical and all that stuff, savage attacks, that.
Yeah.
Just hit the big plus button at the bottom.
Jeez, man, that's cool. You can re-roll your rolls.
That is dope.
That's actually really cool. Of course Colin finds it too, though.
Yeah, did you hit the plus button?
Yeah.
You type in the word lucky.
Okay.
And then it's coming from 4th level druid, right?
Racial, yeah.
It's not racial, it's class.
Oh. Class.
And it's druid, 4th level. And then I would just copy and paste it from the book. You're going to have to reformat it, though, because it's not going to look nice. A bunch of the words will look weird. But when you... then you'll remember you have it. And what I would do also... is above, you see where you have your wild shape that says, it says wild shape and you got 2 uses?
Yeah.
I would write down lucky and then put 3 uses because you get...
Oh, I get another second level spell slot.
You do? Oh, well, you get some other stuff too. We'll get to you.
Ooh-wee.
I'm just trying to get everybody's ability scoring piece of the way. So,
yeah, you do you, honey boo-boo.
Chain, let's talk about Chain.
I did an increase in strength and dexterity.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that was a good choice. Yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
You're a strong boy now.
Yeah, boy. Strong and
defeated. You can swing your sword and shoot your bow. You were up. You were good up close and far away. Skilled in every position.
Let's go.
Especially doggy.
Yes.
Since he was raised by wolves.
What? but yeah, right. So I
okay. Did that. Chris, but yeah. Chris, you're dealt with Yoshi. Yeah. Let me just double check Yoshi fighters. That's all you get, right? Yeah, Marsh. Ability score increase. Perfect. You're dealt with Drothgar. Do you know what you're doing?
Doggy
style.
Oh, Drothgar, you get just now.
I was thinking of either getting my strength to 20.
Ooh. That's big.
Or doing tough, but I don't.
That's also big.
I'm a noob, so I don't know which one.
Good, man. Do whatever you think Drothgar is. Is Drothgar a big, strong, beefy boy that is just going to swing his sword real good? Or is Drothgar a big, strong, beefy boy that is going to be able to take a bunch of hits?
Sorry, Craig. What did you say about putting with my...
I did it already.
Oh, okay.
If you look up where it says wild shape beside it, you'll see luck points 3 out of 3.
You could always let the dice decide for you.
Yeah, you could flip 1 to 2. Both of those are really good choices, though.
I'm doing 20 strength.
20 strength, all right. Do it. So that means that yeah, your strength saves are good. Your athletics just got better. You're great. You swing better with your swords. They do more damage and it's easier to hit. It's really good.
Does who hit better too?
Q? Yeah.
Yay.
I think I unlocked some more animals now, Craig.
Oh, you're right. You do.
Ooh.
Oh my god.
His list gets longer.
Does he get a giant camel?
Other 700 animals. That
oh my goodness!
Yeah, that's I can have swimming speed animals now.
Yeah, give me a second. I have to look up my list.
Did you get the Loch Ness monster?
Druid,
bro.
The Loch Ness.
Get a water dragon.
I can turn into a baby koala.
Where is it? These shapes, bud.
And then, sorry, how many spells can I prepare a day again?
Turn into a puffin.
So now, you, Crest, prepare. If you look in your spellcasting on your main sheet, it'll tell
yeah.
In the book, double check for you though, Druid. Preparing spells. You can prepare a list of Druid spells. You choose a number of spells equal to your Wisdom modifier plus your Druid level.
So
3 plus 4, so 7.
Woohoo! Wow, he gets 7 spells? Dude.
No. He's got the same number of spell slots as you, but he can prepare. He gets like 50 spells, but every day he picks which ones he wants.
Flame Blade? That sounds sick.
Okay, do you guys mind if people have to take pee breaks or something? I would take advantage now. I'm gonna do Colin's animals.
Okay, cool.
Which could take a minute. But I want to make sure.
Craig, if you want, because I'm getting off a little bit earlier, you can just do it later, so we don't have to cut into the time.
It won't take me too
long. Okay.
I'm just gonna be throwing a bunch of. Actually, you know what? Are you okay with not getting them until next time? There's some cool animals. Like a giant seahorse.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah, no. I'm
going to read to you what you get, but I'll add them before next week. Does that sound okay?
Yeah, sounds good.
But I will read to you what you get. You ready? These are your new animals. From weakest to strongest. Frog. Seahorse. Crab. Octopus. Quipper, which is a fish. Giant crab. Poisonous snake, constrictor snake, giant frog, giant poisonous snake, crocodile, giant seahorse, reef shark, giant octopus, and giant toad.
Giant toad?
Giant toad.
That's the strongest?
Wait, it's from Super Mario?
Giant toad is the strongest.
Can't wait to turn into a giant octopus.
A giant toad is like as strong as like a brown bear, dire wolf. Giant hyena, things like that, but it can swim.
That's so sick. I'm gonna be a toad all the time.
Hey! Just wait, when you hit level 6, you can turn into an Allosaurus, which is literally a dinosaur.
Really? I can't wait till I hit toad, and then I can do flying animals, which is so sick.
I can't wait until you hit level 18 and you can turn into a mammoth.
Ooh!
David, next feat I'm taking is you can have one that increases, like, the for when people are riding you, they, like, do it better. I'm going to
When people ride you, they get it better. But if you take mounted compassion, you have to be the one that's riding.
No, I'm going to take the one that makes when people ride me better.
There isn't one.
I swear I was reading about one.
No, that was mounted combatant. That's if they're riding you.
Oh, okay.
I may have to pick that.
Yeah, you have advantage on melee attack rolls.
What does Sentinel do? Doesn't Sentinel...
No, that's not riding. Sentinel is just really good. That's, you know the opportunity attacks when things try and run away from you? You get a free swing?
Yeah.
If you hit somebody with that free swing, they can't move.
Oh, okay.
So if they try to get away and you hit them, they have to stay.
Oh, no, because what I was reading, the person was saying that if they hit your rider, I get to hit them back.
Yeah, that's also true. Because if a creature within 5 feet of you makes an attack against a target other than you, so your rider, then you also get a free attack. Mm. That's also true.
So I'm gonna have to take that big old Drothgar one day.
Sentinel is a dummy feat. Sentinel is one of the best feats. You get two players with Sentinel, and you can lock down an entire room.
At some point, okay, we should figure out a party name as opposed to just calling ourselves The Party.
Yeah, maybe someday.
Yeah.
The Boys. Okay,
the Peen Cutters.
No.
How about never?
I regret making the suggestion.
But you guys rested, so everybody's done their health and leveled up everything they need to level up, right?
Woo!
Zathira, I think, just double checking, Sorcerer, 4th level... You get to learn a new cantrip, Zathira.
I forget what those are.
Those are the free ones, like Firebolt.
Oh, the free spells.
Toll of the Dead.
Yeah.
So you get a new cantrip and a new spell.
What page are
those
on?
That's on your spell list. So I go to spells.
It's like 120 something.
If you go to page 210. You'll see your list of cantrips, and you get to learn a new spell, so you can learn another second level or first level spell.
From that cool! Map.
So, I'm gonna let you do that now if you want, or later, yeah, but we're gonna keep playing. So!
I'm gonna go acid splash, that sounds cool.
Ring. You gotta get prestidigitation. It's literally like a magic trick, the spell, and like produce flowers or light flames and...
Ooh.
Light is also can light. Dancing lights is even better. Floating lights. Anyway, you guys wake up after resting in Radith's cabin, feeling invigorated and strong, ready to face the day ahead. What would you guys like to do?
Turn into a toad?
You do so. A giant toad or a toad?
A giant toad, no.
Well, we still have a lot of the map to uncover. I say a lot, but not in, like, the top bit. But we can move on to the next locale.
I think I'll wait to do my level up, like my spells. Just because it requires a lot of looking up at things.
You never
right now,
know. So. Carlisle might trigger some more twig blights.
Right. Yeah, but the twig blights, they're no problem, especially now that Drothgar has Hue.
Like, I know, now that I have Hue.
He'll hit max on them. Like
every time. Let's go search the rest of this place.
We still haven't explored the top right of this place.
Yes.
That's right. Yeah. So let's just quickly check what's over there.
Let's go explore. Yeah. Let's go explore.
Okay. So I'm going to move up over here because I know this is safe.
Dora.
Okay, thank you for having us over for the night.
Radith, thank you for your kind hospitality.
Thank you very much.
Yoshi.
Respond.
He kind of smiles. He says, oh, well, you know how
Hello?
It is. Can you hear me?
Hello?
Oh, yeah, I can hear you.
Hello? Yes, okay, you can hear me.
Yeah.
Oh, Tony. That's why Tony kept basically ignoring us and talking.
Well, he also went to the washroom.
Tony? No, he was just talking. He was going, hello, hello?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, he just went offline. I think he just completely died.
He's restarting it all.
I have to make a note for y'all.
Hello?
Welcome back, Hi, Tony.
Hello.
I said thank you to Radith. And
yeah,
then,
we know. We could hear you. You just couldn't hear us. You kept talking over everybody.
Pure silence. So I'm like, uh-oh.
You kept talking over everybody, and we were like, Tony. And then you were like, hello?
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 Hello? Oh, it looks like it's your first shift.
As a side note, when you guys come out the next morning, you see that's a thing.
Ooh.
It's just completely burnt down.
That's just ash.
Yep. Just completely destroyed.
Okay, thank you for having us.
Let's go.
Wasn't you, was it?
Post.
No.
No.
That was the dragon.
All right.
No.
All right. right, Drothgar, you were the first to say it. Go ahead and make a deception check at disadvantage, or with advantage, because you're being helped.
Because we're all saying no.
Okay.
Saying no.
A deception check.
A deception, yeah.
You're a liar check.
Ooh.
Yeah, looks you up and down and says, "Oh, those gosh darn cloaked people burning down my woods," and he turns around. He seems to believe you.
Okay. Thanks for having us.
Let us depart post haste.
Oh, wait, we never told him about the cloaked people, did we?
Well, no, he knew. Yeah. He told you. Yeah.
Yeah. He told
us. Yeah,
but
we never told him like what happened to them.
Oh, did something happen to them?
Well, not all of them are dead. I'm part of them now.
Oh. Were they a nice crew?
It turns out they were a dragon cult that worshipped dragons, and the leader was a bit crazy. So Drothgar split him in twain.
And I also joined. Wow.
Yeah.
Joined a cult, killed the leader, and then got to smooch someone.
And two of them got eaten by the dragon. So.
Oh. Sounds like a party.
Yeah, poor Lloyd.
It was wonderful.
Not gonna lie, I don't mind having you kids around. It's nice for a change.
Wait, did Lloyd give me his dragon scimitar?
No, he got eaten. He was gonna give it to
right.
you, and he got eaten.
Wait, so the dragon ate the scimitar too? Lloyd didn't just drop it?
Ate it all.
Jeez, what about... Mary Lou, she didn't have a scimitar or did she keep it with her?
She did, but she left.
Frick, yo!
We can find her in Neverwinter when I need to get this curse off of me.
You think she's still gonna have a dragon scimitar then? She's probably gonna change her ways, but it's nothing to do with the cult.
She changed it dagger. For you.
I don't want the dagger,
anyway,
I want a
scimitar. You guys can all get out of my house now. And
sorry. Out the door.
Okay, bye.
All right. Drothgar just walks away. Nice.
Oh, bye. Okay.
Drothgar, when you step there. No, I'm just kidding.
trap was already triggered.
Who says that traps can't be triggered twice?
Considering how that trap was cobwebs that are burnt to a crisp.
So we killed a dragon, therefore we are undefeated, we are unbeatable, we are invincible,
golden
cool.
Golden gods!
Yeah, I mean, listen, if the dragon's not gonna kill us, what is?
So, as you guys...
As you step there...
Famous last words. The most famous of last words.
What's the worst that can happen?
Yeah. If a dragon can't kill us, what can? Followed immediately by death. It looks like you're looking into that building. Alright. Just let me open up my documento here. Alright.
There's a door up there. We can kick that door down.
Oh, actually, give me a hot minute. This music is far too happy. There is no more peace. You are out in creepy land, so...
Crest is still, like, hanging by the door.
I don't know if Colin's...
I was farting in his house.
Is the immense fog still a thing, or is the fog lifted?
Fog is everywhere all the time.
Oh.
On the east side of town, the lane opens to form a small square. Several ruined buildings surround the south side of the square, but a larger, intact structure to the north... Looks like a barracks. One lane leads southeast, another heads southwest, and around the hill to the middle of town. A third way meanders north, and in the middle of the square, leaning to one side ever so slightly, is a weathered wooden statue of a warrior clutching a spear and shield.
Can I inspect the statue?
Sure. What would you like to look at it?
I want to see if maybe, like, there's anything special about it.
Go ahead and make a history check.
That is there. Wow. Did anyone help me with that?
It's a wood. You gotta stop asking. No. Doesn't look. It's a wooden statue. It's about 10 feet tall.
It's a stupid statue, anyway. Can I cast Burning Hands on it?
To.
Can I check to see if there's anything inside this little place here, like a perception check or whatever?
Sure. Well, while you were inspecting the statue, the rest of you, you guys want to do anything?
I would like to check out this building over here.
Sure, you saw it is ruined and messy.
I see that it's messy. You kind of cut out a little bit.
Yep, ruined and messy and nothing really of note.
Cool. Okay. I would like to search more thoroughly if possible.
Sure, you can make a perception check.
No, it's not allowed. Yes,
it is very messy.
In fact, it looks more messier than it did before. Okay. Who next?
Anybody else want to do anything?
I want to knock on this door.
What?
You don't want to break it down?
You. There doesn't appear to be an answer.
I open the door.
Okay. As you open the door.
I don't like the way he said okay.
Yeah, neither do I.
Okay.
Lunging at you from behind the door.
I have 41 health, so it's okay.
Two Zambos jump out and lunge at you immediately.
Should have kicked down the door.
And we are going to roll
initiative.
Go ahead and roll initiative, y'all.
Amazing how one person can just put everyone into combat.
Man, everybody has to react.
Yoshi! Carlisle!
This is what happens when the rogue level up.
I was on the pan view. Sorry, one second.
These are special zombies, too. I hope you're excited.
Oh!
Did everybody roll their initiative?
Yep.
Alright, first to act, Yoshi. You really see these zombies jump out to attack Drothgar. What do you want to do?
I'm gonna Lombo that guy.
Alright, let's see it.
That guy.
Ooh, and already we can see it is that newly added dexterity is serving you well as thunk, the arrow sinks into it. It flinches a little bit, but not that much. But also, as soon as he's hit Drothgar, there is a of ash that comes out of his body. I need you to make a constitution saving.
They're working.
It's okay, you have 40 HP.
Where's Constitution? There it is.
Woo!
Yeah, dash doesn't bug you at all. Yoshi, you want to move?
Yeah. I'll roll over here.
Okay. Carlisle, you're up.
Yes, sir.
You were looking around in this building, you're like, wow, it's really messy, and then you hear noises.
I'm like, oh, okay.
And somehow he manages to react faster than Drothgar.
Yeah, man.
I run over here, and I take out my crossbow, thank you, and aim for right between the zombie's eyes.
All right.
Let's see it.
Ooh, whoa. You hit right between the Zambo's eyes. Go ahead and roll the sneak attack as well.
Jeez.
Are you? No, you get more than 1d6 now. You're a level 4 rogue.
I'll have to edit that.
Yeah. In fact, I'm going to do something for you to be a nice guy. Do you want me to be a nice guy for you?
Yes, please. Thank you.
Craig's the best DM ever.
Watch. No, this is the product of playing way too much on Roll20. All right, watch this.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to add on all of your attacks a special second damage called 2d6 sneak. Okay?
Sounds cool.
So basically, all of your attack. Oh, I forgot to hit the check. Oh, no, I didn't. So basically, all of your attacks, your weapon attacks, will do an extra 2d6 sneak, and if it applies, we'll add it, and if it doesn't apply, we won't add it.
Well, thank you.
Because that way, we don't ever have to really worry about it rolling or not. Mm-hmm.
I do have a question. I do have a question as well, but I'll wait until after the.
Yeah, what's up?
Oh, do I get another spell slot or no?
I don't know. Check.
I currently have two. Out. Yeah, we can wait until afterwards. It's not gonna. I don't think it's gonna be pertinent.
Make or break us with two Zambles.
Okay, there. Your sneak attack should be added. Go ahead and roll another d6 for me.
Well, it's a 1d6.
You already rolled one, so just slash R 1d6.
Okay, thank you.
So, did you do slash R space
one? Sorry.
All right.
You do the same amount as if it was just a nat 20.
At fourth level, yeah, you should have a third first level spell slot. And you learn a new spell.
Oh, thank you.
Off the wizard spell list.
All right, I will.
So you can do that while you wait for your next turn. Would you like to move? Oh, you have a little bit of movement.
No, I'll stay here.
Okay, on the Zambo's turns, these two are going to take slam attacks at you. Drothgar?
Mm-hmm. Do they just slam their chest up against them?
No, they're fists. That's a 12 and a 14 to hit.
No, yes.
Okay, this one also runs out.
Oh, wonderful.
Wait.
Runs out and hits you. This one also runs out what? And is going to hit you. This one also runs out. So, you get hit by 5 slams total, so I'm gonna roll the other 3 real quick.
My goodness.
Listen, you decided to just straight up open the door.
Alright, 6, 10. So you take a total of 16 points of bludgeoning damage.
Jeez.
Okay, I have 40 hit points.
3 of them did hit, and 2 of them didn't, as they just run around the corners just start slamming up against you with great aggression. Drothgar, it is your turn.
So 16?
Yeah, 16. Because you're not raging. You're not raging yet, so.
Yeah. Wow.
Would you like to rage?
Yes, I would.
Anger. Alright, you anger. And then.
And so, should I just try Hugh out, or should I greatsword him?
It's up to you.
Why would you not try Hugh? It's a magic weapon.
Okay, I guess I'll hue it up.
With two-handed or one-handed?
I'm gonna two-hand.
Nice.
The zomble in front of me.
You sink it into his head, cleave down into his body. 12. 6, 17.
Oh, plus 2 because I'm raging.
Okay, and as you cleave it, it collapses, shudders for a second, but does not get up.
Oh.
Nice.
Nice.
Would you like to move at all?
Yeah, I wanna.
They're gonna get free swings at you, just to let you know. Two of them are.
No, I don't wanna move.
Okay. Just letting you know. Alright, crusty baby! You see, all of a sudden, Drothgar seems like he's being accosted by some Zambos.
I'm gonna walk up to here. Right there.
That's 30 feet.
And I'm gonna cast Thunder Wave.
He's not gonna turn Drothgar too. Nice.
What level do I get to cast this at?
Well, you can cast that first or second. You have both. You're going to hit Drothgar too, just so you know.
Punishment for just opening the door.
So when you, so let me just double
check.
I'll
heal him back up.
You better.
When you cast, I just want to check something, Colin. Sorry.
Yeah. Drothgar, don't you still have 3 healing potions?
2.
You still have the ones I gave you?
Yeah.
When we had our moment.
Yeah.
Yeah, so yeah. when you click on Thunder, does it ask you?
Yeah, it asked me what level I want to cast. I'm on that menu right now.
Okay, great, yeah. So just click whatever level you want to cast it at. Just mark off the right spell slot.
Just gonna click the biggest one.
All right, Drothgar, can you make a Constitution save for me?
Oh my goodness. Yep, I can.
They all failed, so they're gonna take. Oh, Drothgar also failed. So Drothgar, you take 12 halved to 6, so you take 6 points of.
Oh my, that's nothing. That's nothing.
Take 6. Six.
You're
points.
A beefy boy.
19. I'm at 19 health.
You're a beefy boy.
Famous last words. It's okay. I got 40 hit points.
You're at 41. You lost 16. How are you at 19 now? Is that how that works?
41 minus 16 is 25, right?
41 minus 16 minus 6. 25. Right?
Minus
yeah,
six,
19.
Yeah,
holy 19. Smokes. Yeah, you got wrecked.
Yeah.
And Drothgar, I need you to make 2 more constitution saves.
Oh my goodness.
As the there is ash that just spreads all over your face. Oh no, you failed one. Drothgar, you have disadvantage on all your attacks for your next turn because there's just ash all in your eyes and your nose and you're coughing. It's just all over everything.
Did I kill any of them at least?
No. They all
no.
Can you guys like take them off of me? Like
Zephira, you're up. Oh, sorry. Yeah, that's all your movement as well, Cross.
Is this is this a window?
This is a window. Yeah, it's a window.
So if I go there, I can cast through it.
This would drop down my ball.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Then, wait, hang on.
Ah, skeet.
Then I'm going to move here.
Aww.
Or does it matter if I move here? No, yeah, I have to move here. Yeah, that's my 30 feet. Can I hit all of them with burning hands?
You have to start on yourself when you use the ruler. So click on yourself.
Also gonna hit Drothgar.
If you want to hit all of them, the angle you'd have to aim it this way. So yes, you would hit Drothgar, but then. Hit all of them.
It's okay. Hit him. He deserves it.
Why do I deserve this?
I don't know.
If I angle it this way, can I hit the 3 and not Drothgar?
Because of the size of the cone and where Drothgar is, if you want to hit all of them.
Yeah, but I'm saying if I don't hit the one in the corner and I angle it down like this, can I hit the 3 of them?
Yes, you can hit the back 3 without hitting Drothgar.
Okay, well then I'll do that.
All right, go ahead.
I'm gonna cast Burning Hands.
Thank you.
You know what, baby? I got you. Don't worry.
Remember
see, you
when like...
just because Crust gives you health potions, he's your boy? No, your girl's got your back.
All right.
Remember when my cult hands. Leader asked me to attack you and I didn't?
Yeah, second level Burning Hands.
Ah, really bad damage.
But I can reroll the damage.
That's not quite how that works.
Isn't it?
You can reroll a number of damage die up to your charisma modifier if you spend a sorcery. I can't remember how many sorcery points it is for empowered spell.
Empowered spell. When you roll damage for a spell, you can spend 1 sorcery point to reroll a number of the damage dice up to your charisma modifier.
Okay, so just 1 sorcery point, and then you can reroll. Oh, and your charisma modifier is 4, so you can reroll it all.
Yeah, so I just click it again then?
You can, yeah, and just hit the second level.
Hang on. Spells. Crap. Where'd he go? Burning Hands.
Do you want to reroll the 5, though? Because you rolled 5 on one of the dice. On the 4th one.
So what do you mean?
Okay, so you rolled 4d6 in total, right?
Yeah.
Got a 2, a 1, a 2, and a 5. Do you want to reroll all 4, or do you only want to roll 3?
I'm going to reroll the 3 low ones.
Okay, so then don't do it at second level, just do it at first.
Just do it at first? Okay. Ooh.
Much better. So that's 16 damage, and they all fail their saves, and
mark
they
off 1 point.
Burst into flame and burn away. They're
yeah.
There.
Yeah, boy. Your girl's got your back, Drothgar, okay?
Thank you, baby.
Zathira and her...
Your girl's got your back, Drothgar.
Chocolate. Chocolate.
Yoshi, what would you like to do?
Chocolate. I remember. Oh, yeah. Chocolate.
Can I hit him from here?
No. You're going to have a hard time hitting him with your bow. You can move in and hit him with your sword, but you're going to have a really hard time hitting him with your bow.
All right,
oh,
I'll
you have Talon.
I'll move in, and then I'll use my
double-handed talon.
When you say it like that, it makes it awful. Oh, you cut his head off it. It falls over and is dead.
Yeah.
It's brutal.
Yeah.
You guys are out of the fighting.
I'm gonna cast Cure Wounds on Jothgar.
You're gonna cast what?
Cure Wounds on Jothgar.
Kill Wounds?
Cure.
Oh, I care about food.
Oh, that was a much
you cast that second level for
it? No way.
That's 10 hit points. Did you cast that? It looks like you cast it at second level for it.
I did.
Yeah, so that's 10 hit points. It's really good.
I got you, babe.
Now you're back up to 29 hit points.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. All right. Do we want to just blindly run through these doors or maybe check for traps and stuff? I see there is a ladder here.
Well, I am way out here, so I'm going to just kind of walk in and kind of like lightly brush everyone aside and say, just let me do my job.
Do your job.
Wonder who thought of that one.
Go ahead and make an investigation check. Ooh. You use your eyeballs real good. This place is not trapped.
Cool. So, we're in luck with this hallway. Where do we want to go? Up or through the...
Oh, the doors aren't trapped. You're good.
Okay.
I want to open this door.
Boom. Oh, no.
What?
Okay. No, he said the doors aren't trapped.
Yeah. Just...
Looking through, it looks like there's piles of rotted sacks and some bunk beds.
These nut sacks.
There's some bunk beds and a pantry that's kind of falling apart. And there's a ladder going upstairs to a trapdoor in the ceiling.
Can I make an investigation check to see if there's anything more than just rotting stuff?
Sure.
Where's investigation? Why can't I not...
In your skills, in alphabetical order.
Yeah, I know, it's in my skills. I just... My brain, for whatever reason.
You see, there's just rotting stuff.
XLPQRCY.
I vote we go upstairs.
I agree.
I am just
Drothgar, alone. Do you want to lead the way? Or does anyone else want to lead the way?
I will lead the way. I feel bad for running away.
for running away against the dragon.
You gonna open the door, trap door? Or what are you gonna do?
I would like to... Is it unlocked? Can I...
It's unlocked.
Cool. I would like to check to make sure it's not trapped.
Investigation.
Sorry, I'm still in my spells. Hold on.
Never forgive you. It looks fine.
Cool. I poke my head through and look around.
You are hit with the immediate smell of death and rotting everything. It looks like up here was like a storage room of some kind that someone died in. And also there's like dead, like rotting meat and like vegetables. And it's just awful.
There's a dead person up there.
You just, it's like I'm trying. I have a hairball. I'm just kind of like, I continue upwards, and I go like, I kind of like lean back down and go, you might want to cover your nose. And just I continue upwards into the room.
Is there a separate thing for the room, or is it just like the room?
I think he's pulling it up.
The room.
The room.
The loft.
Can we kick down the door?
Can we kick down the trap door?
In the ceiling? You can kick up the door.
Well, I was going to say, like, I would like to continue up into the room.
Yeah, you go up and in the room, and it smells like poop.
Great. Ah.
I want to join him up there, and I want to search the body.
Cover your nose.
Yeah, you get up there, Zathira. It smells rank. That's go ahead, make an investigation check. You find rotting flesh, bones, Death.
May I also make an investigation check to look around?
Sure, but it'll last.
Can I help him with it, or is it because I rolled too bad?
Too late. Too late.
Oh, it doesn't need help.
You find bones and death.
I believe we should vacate this.
I want to leave the room. Can I cast a firebolt to just burn this place down?
I immediately jump down the trapdoor.
If you really want to.
I don't think this place should stay standing. This poor soul deserves a cremation.
We just don't know what's behind door number 3 here.
That's the backyard.
If it
that's
smells
like the exit.
Isn't
oh, really?
It when well,
you
oh,
look
boy.
At it, yeah.
Okay,
I'm gonna cast a firebolt into the back corner right beside the dead body.
Sure, you light up the place, the building catches fire, and suddenly Crust, you're down on the first floor and you see the ceiling is on fire and starting to fall apart.
I'm gonna
walk out.
Yoshi,
turn into a camel.
Carlisle just jumps down the trapdoor and like beep 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 out the door.
The building is on fire.
Want to check the only other building we haven't explored?
We're just gonna let this one burn too.
Yeah. Burn. It's filled with nothing but death and decay. We don't need to keep this place safe for anything.
Burn, baby, burn.
I really don't want to just let this one burn. I feel like if you look at the surrounding area, I feel like this one is.
Listen.
No, I'm not listening. That's why I'm suggesting.
If you want to deal with it, that's on you. Okay,
that's what I'm trying to figure out. If I can,
there was nothing we could do. It's what's done is done. I cast my firebolt. It's burning.
Can I cast my chromatic orb in there and do water damage to attempt to extinguish the flame?
You really want to use a spell slot on it, but the building is on fire.
Then
you should.
And also, I don't think there's such thing as water damage.
I know there's. There's not.
Yeah.
Okay.
You take 10 wet.
I just kind of slowly turn around and I'm like, if this gets any worse, it's on your head.
Listen, the only person that really lives here is Radoff and Brutus, so.
And he let us sleep in his camp. He was very hospitable.
Yeah. Well, blame it on the zombies.
You threw the firebolt
at the zombies. Listen, if the place didn't burn down when I cast Burning Hands, so...
I turn around and walk away.
Okay. Drothgar.
I wanna inspect this house down here.
Well, you can't. You just Tony's just everywhere at once.
Tony's
so...
just everywhere. Carlisle's so... like, oh, okay. Kill a dragon.
While you were talking to Carlisle, yeah. All right, you gotta let other people play too, man. Drothgar, you're walking down here. It looks like.
Yeah.
You want to look in this building?
I would like to look at this building.
That's the building.
Peek inside.
Yep. I'm going in, and I'm just going to... Can I make a perception check?
There are heaps of wreckage littering the interior of this room.
Can I search more thoroughly?
Sure, make an investigation check.
Okay.
There are heaps of wreckage littering the interior of this ruin.
All right. Guys, let's go.
Craig, is there anything over here, or is that just kind of like...
What are you talking about? Over where?
Like, by the compass? Like, if you fully zoom out on the bottom left corner of the map, it's still like a black square. Is that just kind of...
My legend.
Oh. So, it's nothing.
You guys have successfully explored every inch of the ruins of Thunder Tree.
Yay, what's next?
So, on job, that guys. Note, unfortunately, I have to leave a little early this week.
That's okay.
Yeah, but why? I will be here next week for the whole thing, unless I'm at my trailer.
Why are you leaving us, Colin?
One of my good buddies, his dad recently got diagnosed with cancer, and... He's also going through a breakup, so I'm just going to spend some time with him, make sure he's doing good and stuff.
I will accept this answer.
I'm glad. But have fun, boy.
That got real dark real fast.
Yeah, I was gonna not mention it because it is kind of a bummer, but
oh man.
I deem this not worthy of you.
All right, boys, have fun.
Bye.
Bye.
See you guys.
Bye.
Love you all.
See you, man.
Bye. Love you, man.
That took a turn. That was almost as
I knew exactly where he was going too. I just didn't want to say anything.
It was almost as much of a roller coaster as the dragon fight.
Jeez.
It's like what happened with me and Steph.
You and
it
who?
Went really great. Yeah, so she said no.
You and Helena?
No, when I said the R word.
Oh, oh yes.
Gosh.
Wait, what? What?
David, especially when I made that comment
this
too.
This is on live stream.
Yeah. Don't worry, but she doesn't watch live. Anyway.
In my comment too. Land. Land.
Oh my goodness. The good times.
Okay, so do we want to leave Thunder Tree now?
Yes, let's leave Thunder Tree.
Alright, you guys decide you are done with this ruin, and you turn and you walk out of Thunder Tree back into
leaving the
world.
Building on fire.
The building burns the whole down until you're gone. The entire Neverwinter Wood burns down because of homelessness.
The Krogs? Nice.
What? Alright, you guys had a few other places that you wanted to go.
I believe next was Agatha's lair, wasn't it?
I believe you are correct.
Should we
watch this fight? Turns out to be there's a fight there that turns out to be worse than the dragon.
Should we quickly go to Neverwinter so I can?
You just want to hook up.
No, so I can get rid of my curse.
To be fair,
liar,
he is plagued by a demonic curse right now,
and it is causing physical harm on me, which I had to make a saving check from.
Yeah, I guess we should make a pit stop.
Hey,
and
Craig, now that we're out of Thunder Tree, why was I making 1d100 rolls?
I'm not telling you. You don't get to know these things, Tony. You can't ever know.
Well, I need to know!
So
that's not how it works. You have to accept that you know nothing and I know everything.
Yes.
It's part of the deal.
Yeah, it's one of the hardest things to get your head around. I still have problems with it.
Okay, so does the party want to go to Neverwinter or say screw Drothgar, let's go to Agatha's lair?
I say that we should support our party member and go and find the solution to his problem that he brought upon himself.
Thank you.
That problem being he needs to get laid. Okay.
And
let's go to Neverwinter.
Yay!
You guys can watch.
Also,
I told you I was watching.
Also, right. For my spell, I chose magic missile.
Oh, now you both have magic missiles.
Yes.
All right, y'all are gonna follow the river down through to Neverwinter. It's gonna take you about a day to get there.
The hobbits of Isengard. Because it takes a day, does it kind of count as like a long rest?
You will get another long rest.
Tell me where is Gandalf, for I much desire to speak with him.
So like all of our spells and health is recharged?
Yeah, yeah. By the time you get there. But you guys have like a day of walking and stuff together. You guys are gonna get to Neverwinter around midday, but while you're journeying along the river's edge, you guys want to do anything? Talk about anything? Ask any questions? What are you guys up to?
Yoshi! I want to, like, crack Yoshi open, you know?
Sorry.
Yo, crack me open, like, I don't know, man. We're live stream.
Like a Kinder Egg.
Yeah.
I want him to open up to us, you know?
Just Yoshi, 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 Yoshi.
Literally.
Well,
Yoshi.
Sure.
Yoshi.
How are you gonna try to get him to open up?
Hey, Yoshi.
I kind of want to see this play out.
Yo.
Do you say anything besides Yoshi?
He just shakes his head. He's like a tear dropped down his face.
Aww.
And he just shakes his head.
Aww.
Like a little gerbil.
Okay, no, let's just...
Because if you remember, a couple games ago, I was like, if I cast Comprehend Languages, would I be able to understand? No, I don't. He just says Yoshi.
So, did you try anything else, or did you give up at that
point? I mean, tears were drawn.
Can...
I'm not gonna do anymore.
I was gonna say, would Carlisle see like be it within be able to see the tears on his face?
Is there walking together? I don't know. Is it an obvious tear, Yoshi, or is it?
Oh yeah, yeah. It's like there's like streams of tears coming down his face.
I walk over, I give
Yoshi a hug.
Yeah, I walk over, I take my bat-like cloak and I try to wash away his tears and give him a great big hug. Aww.
And cuddle and then
I wrap my tail around him.
And I immediately let go.
I am not making any physical contact during this time.
Exercising social distancing, yeah.
Yeah, then because of that hug, that love he received, he started speaking English.
What? What? Really?
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 He started speaking words, but it's not like full sentences. He's like, yo, yes? Like, so like slowly, like, becoming normal, but it's not fully just, like, yet, though.
Full on breaks into, oh,
yo!
That was such a wonderful embrace.
Yeah.
So he stutters out like a yes?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So he's like stuttering, but it's not like full sentences. So he's starting to gain your guys' trust, but it's not full yet.
Aww. He was waiting for a hug.
I go back to give him
love. All he wanted was love.
What is love? Yeah. What is love? Baby, don't hurt me.
Oh,
don't
man.
Hurt me no more. That?
I love that. So you guys managed to get Yoshi to utter but a syllable that is not Yoshi. But
we've cracked into Yoshi's inner
core. Progress, you guys can see his shell is chipping away just a little bit. Maybe someday you will understand why this little meatball follows you around.
Literally.
You're not sure. Like, I think we all have to just take into context the fact that, like, he was there to help you with this whole thing with Gundren. And then he's just kind of been rolling around with you guys for the rest of it. Like, he's never...
But he's stick with a longbow, though.
Rolling with a longbow, he's just says Yoshi a bunch, and... Yeah. Got places to go. Gotta follow my rainbow.
Can't stick around, gotta keep moving on.
Thank you, Zach. Appreciate that. But by about noon on... noon the next day, Neverwinter comes into view.
Oh!
Sure.
Guys, we made it to Neverwinter.
All right, let's break a curse.
Do you guys want a picture?
Wait, did you switch the map? Picture?
No, I'm going to.
Oh.
Just give me a good minute, man. What are you guys playing? No, you're not playing.
Lost Mains of Fambadelbader.
Okay, and I will add a page just so that you guys have it. Nevre Wantre.
Always summer.
Yes, good old always summer.
It's always sunny in Philadelphia.
It's always sunny in winter. Do you guys know why it's called Neverwinter?
Because it's never winter.
Because it's never winter.
Do you know why it's never winter there?
Because it's always summer.
Would you like to know why, or do you care?
Yes, I want the lore.
You want that good lore?
I want that good lore.
Give me a sec. Map.
It's always sunny in Philadelphia.
It's always sunny.
Philadelphia cream cheese.
Well, that's still... It's a big picture. It's not actually a... But it's a big image that you guys can zoom in and zoom in. Be like, oh look, Nevre Wantre. Player. Turn off the grid so it's just a nice picture, and we'll drop you Neverwinter.
Oh. Hey.
It's beautiful.
Yo.
So the reason Neverwinter is called Neverwinter is because the river that you guys followed down here flows down from Mount Hotnow, which is actually a volcano. That water is very warm, and because the warm water carries through Neverwinter, it's constantly warm there. Not like sweltering hot, but it's hot enough, like warm enough, that in the winter time it's like it's fall because the water warms the land and everything.
Hmm.
So it never really, like, it might snow, but the snow melts, which is pretty.
So it's never winter.
Yeah, wow. Welcome to Neverwinter. It is a beautiful, big, bustling city, and immediately you're reminded of just how small the towns you've been to is. There are just people everywhere of every race imaginable. It is bustling.
Is it like the olden day version of downtown Toronto?
Yeah, it's fantasy Toronto.
It's like Asgard.
Yeah, I want to go to the CN Tower of Neverwinter.
Oh.
maybe we should ask somebody where we can find a priest.
Yeah.
And then sightsee.
So you just want to, like, grab someone?
Just, you know, maybe, like, see if there's a guard somewhere or someone who looks like they know the place, you know?
You definitely see the city guard.
Okay. I'm going to walk up to the gardens. Good day. Is it a sir? Is it a ma'am? Good sir. My friend here has gotten himself in a predicament, and we require a priest. Is there a priest here?
The man, he's like taller, broad shoulders, really square chin. Looks very official. Looks down and says, "Right, yeah, we got lots of priests. What's your fancy?"
Preferably one that's able to break demonic cult curses.
Sounds like your friend needs to go to jail instead of anything else.
Wow.
No, I can assure you jail's not what he needs.
Right. Listen, I don't know anything about breaking curses, but I can tell you a little bit about temples you got right here.
Okay. I mean, yeah, sure. If there's like a well-known priest around in one of those temples, that'd be real good.
I don't know any of the priests. I pay my dues to pay the worry once in a while, but
you know anything about your like religions, about pagan religions and stuff? Do you know Tiamat, the god Tiamat?
Well, why would you say her name? That's like, she's a baddie.
Okay, yeah. But I'm just asking, what god was the god that, you know, threw Tiamat into hell or whatever?
What? You really don't know, do you?
No, I don't.
It's kind of pathetic.
Well, you're looking kind of scrawny, and so I want to get this curse off of me, so you better speak up.
All right, my goodness. Yeah, you're looking for the Temple of Bahamut.
Yes, where can I find the Temple of Bahamut?
It's just through the streets up, and he gives you directions.
Okay, I'm going there.
Thank you, good sir.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Take care. Make sure you don't end up with any more weird cults.
Yeah, that is. We'll talk to his parents about it. Don't worry.
Okay. He kind of like looks away.
So do we like just directly go there, or
you can?
I'm going there.
Okay, I'll follow Drothgar. I want to make sure he gets this done.
Maybe right. Mary Lou's in the temple too.
You take some time to. Did she tell you where she was gonna?
She said she'll be in Neverwinter.
Are you sure?
Yeah, she did. She said she'll like find me in Neverwinter or something like that.
Yeah,
but the first thing she was gonna do was get the curse off of her. So.
So you wander your way through the streets for some time, passing through the city, and eventually you find yourself in like a holy district where there's like a bunch of churches. You see churches to a bunch of gods. You see a church to
false idols,
Corellon and Arathis and Ayun, and Kord, Melora, Moradin and Pelor, like a whole bunch of them, just a butt ton. But eventually, you do find the Temple of Bahamut. It is depicted. It is a giant building that is glistening with like a silver sheen, and on in front of it, there's a big dragon's head, a big platinum dragon's head in profile, plastered on the front of the building.
I think we found it. Now, do we want to knock, enter, or kick down the door?
What?
I just want to enter.
I was gonna say we
calmly enter.
You make your way up the steps, and the big double doors are open. You step inside, and you can see it's a huge temple. Beautiful, and inside there's braziers all lit. There's a big, at the far end of the room that you step into, which is kind of like an auditorium, there's like pews, and then at the front there's a big blue carpet that makes its way all the way down to the front, where there's a massive statue of a platinum dragon, arms out or wings outstretched, rearing backward and looking down at the people below it. And there's a few people that look like they're in priest's attire moving back and forth, and currently there are not many patrons, like, other than the priests. You see a couple people up at the front kneeling in prayer. Quiet.
Do I see Mary Lou?
Go ahead and make a perception check.
Nat one. Can I help him with it?
Don't jinx it.
So I'm still on the photo on the screen. Is it supposed to be like a map or something?
Dang it.
No, it's just a photo.
Oh, okay.
Around, you don't see her.
Okay. I need a priest.
Did you yell that?
Yeah.
Okay, you see like four people like turn towards you and look. And they kind of look at one another. And finally, an elven man with this long silver hair that falls down his back. He's wearing beautiful silver robes.
Daddy.
Trimmed with like blue. And this elf, he walks up to you. He smiled. Says, "Hello.
Who said you're a priest?
I am a priest.
I'm in great need of help, sir.
Of course, may we call me Geriot.
Geriot?
Geriot, yes.
May we converse
or
about
Jerry
this?
To my
I kind of lean over and whisper into Drothgar's ear. Maybe we should talk about this somewhere less conspicuous.
Can we go somewhere private?
Yeah, sure, Jerry. What?
I'm just saying to Tony, he doesn't know everything. Just deep breath.
Yeah.
Let other people talk too.
I mean,
all right. Yeah. So,
Jerry, have you ever dealt with curses from demonic cults before?
He raises an eyebrow. Is that I think you better come with. leads you guys back into the building, out of the main auditorium, through a hallway, and eventually into like a side like office area that's like got nice little depictions of the platinum dragon around. There's some candles, there's like a closet full of different robes, and there's like a big desk, and he goes and he sits behind the desk, and he gestures to some chairs. He says, please sit.
Thank you.
No, thank you very much.
Are we all in here? Or is it just
yes, please, you can all of you. Okay. Step in. Kind of gestures around. He says, now, you'll have to forgive me. This is a direct question, but were you involved in a cult of Tiamat in Thunder Tree?
Yeah.
I believe a friend of yours came by very recently. Do you know a woman named Mary Lou, an elven woman?
I do. Have you seen her?
Yes, she's still here somewhere.
Really?
Yeah. Yes, she's helping in return, I guess, a form of payment for the services rendered. She did not have enough money to pay for the spell required, to pay for the donation for the spell, but so she's working to pay it off.
Well, is there any way you can bring her here right now?
I think we should deal with your first.
All right. Well, I
dropped her too thirsty.
No, I was gonna pay for her, but I need the exact same treatment that she had.
Wait, do we pay for her as in we pay for her? Or pay for her spell that pay was...
pay for her to be fixed.
I gotta clean my... I spit my Pepsi all over my microphone.
Oh, jeez.
But I need... Yes, I need the same treatment that she has received.
She says, very well, that's 100 gold. It will cost a donation of 100 gold pieces, but we can do it.
All right.
Did you just hand him 100 gold?
Well, can we bargain?
I mean, you can try, but like, if I only ask because 100 gold is not a small amount of money. So if you just hand him 100 gold, his eyes will go wide and be like, "Oh, okay, dokie," and he'll do it. But yeah.
Could I give you 80?
Make a persuasion check at disadvantage.
Persuasion check, disadvantage.
You didn't need the disadvantage.
I'm sorry, it is less of a donation and more the material components required for the ritual do cost a significant amount. It's 100 gold or nothing.
Would you be interested in the head of a doppelganger?
What?
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 No? Okay.
No! Why would I want the head of anything? That's horrifying.
Ours. All right. Maybe.
Listen, I have 100 gold.
Oh, perfect.
All right. I give it to him.
All right, you give him a small sack of gold. He takes the gold. He says, thank you. He puts it underneath his desk, and he comes back with some incense, and he and like a paintbrush almost, and some ink, some paints. He says, come here. And he kind of like pulls your arm and sets it out on the table. And he begins to take like the brush and he dips it in like the paint and slowly draws these runes up your arm. And he lights the incense and he mutters a few words and the runes on your arm flash this white light. And the painting is gone, and you feel this, like, snapping in your head, as if a chain link was just torn apart by raw force. And he smiles, and he says, I think that should do it.
Thank you very much.
Can I ask a question?
Of course.
If the materials required are very expensive, why is it just incense and ink?
It's very expensive incense and ink blessed by priests and treated specially to attain holy properties.
So
it's not ink.
It's not something that you can walk into a store and just be like, and I want that, and I want that.
Good, lesser restoration.
Oh, look, a scroll for Wish.
Did you say Mary Lou was still here?
She is.
All right, I'm going to go find her.
Hang on, I have a second question regarding Mary Lou. How much does she still owe?
Yeah, true.
It's only been a day or so since she's been here. Probably 90 gold.
Interesting.
Hang
on.
Well, in all honesty, a day's wages working here in the temple is more like 2 gold, so she owes about 98 gold.
Would you be interested in a very special goblet? And I kind of like wave my hands towards Carlisle to show him one of the nice goblets we have.
Oh yeah.
Yes. And I take out one of the goblets worth 60 GP.
But he doesn't know how much it's worth.
No, but that's what I have it written down in my items.
He looks at it. He says, may I? And he holds out his hand to take a look at it.
And I gingerly pass it over to him.
He turns it over in his hand, and you see him like touch the moonstones. It's inlaid with these 4 moonstones, and it's made of silver. And he looks and he says, actually, this could be fairly useful. In some of our rituals that we require. For this goblet, I will consider Mary Lou's debt paid.
if we're all in agreement.
I am very well in agreement. I would like to very much. I know Drothgar is.
Yoshi, do you agree? Yes. Do you concur?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Power words.
In exchange for Mary Lou's debt, you may have the goblet.
Thank you. And he takes the goblet and he sees him walk over to a shelf and put it inside a nice case. And he says, well, you can go tell her the news. He smiles.
Okay. Let's leave.
Before we go aimlessly searching for her, do you know where she is in the temple?
I believe she was in prayer at the moment.
Okay. There we go. All right, Drothgar, you lead the way, buddy.
I want to yell out, Mary Lou!
Okay, as you guys rush out the room, Yoshi, you're the last to leave. And right before you leave, Yoshi, the priest, Jerry, he says, excuse me, young man.
And then I'm like, yes.
He looks, he says...
I'm like shaking at this point.
He kind of walks up to you and he squats down. So that he's like even with you. He has to squat quite a bit. He says, you remind me of someone I knew some time ago. Are you all right?
And then, so Yoshi, he like takes that info and he starts crying again.
Oh dear.
And then he shakes his head.
He says, dear, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to, and he pulls, like, a handkerchief off of a shelf and hands it to you. It's embroidered with an image of the profiled head of a dragon.
And then I rip it off from your hands and I blow into it, and then, yeah, then I give it back to you all, like,
snoggy. Soggy, and he's like, oh, lovely. And he just kind of steps down on his desk and he says, well, you know, this may be difficult, but... If you ever need to talk to somebody, the Temple of Bahamut is here for.
And then Yoshi just nods his head, and then he rolls out.
Okay.
Yoshi, yes.
He rolls away. He says, and we just kind of we get a glimpse of him kind of looking at us. Huh. Weird. And then he closes the door. We get a smash cut to Drothgar. Bursting into the chamber, Mary Lou, and everybody again, once again, turns to look at Drothgar as he says, "I need." His two entrances have been, "I need a priest," and and everybody kind of looks at you, and then they all turn and look at one of the people kneeling in prayer at the front, and slowly standing up and looking over her shoulder. Eyes wide and mouth open in surprise, she sees you standing there. It's like the world moves in slow motion.
I love how the music is like. It's like at the right moment.
She looks at you for a minute and she says, you came so soon.
I'm here.
And
guess what we did?
What did you do?
The curse has been lifted from you, and we paid the debt on your behalf. Or on our... We paid your debt. We paid your debt.
I'm gonna go wide, and she, as she processes what she just said, she... Drothgar, and she runs and throws her arms around you, and her head falls into your chest, and she sobs, and it's beautiful. She looks up at you, tear sparkles in her eyes, and says, free. I'm finally free.
Carlisle just kind of leans into the rest of the party. I think we should leave. I think they need a moment.
Let's just go, let's step like, outside. Congregate to the back of the building.
Well, I was going to say, let's just take a breath of fresh air. Let's just go outside.
I'll lean into Drothgar and be like, we'll catch you outside, buddy.
Hey, you guys shuffle out of the room and go outside.
That was awkward, wasn't it? Oh my gosh.
Mary Lou kind of looks up at you, Drothgar, and says, so, what will you do now?
Well, there's still many adventures that await for me, and I don't know what will become of my future, but what I do know is I love you.
Gonna miss you.
And she looks up at you and she goes, Wait, actually, make a persuasion check.
Oh no!
I don't know if she was ready for the L word.
She better be.
When you said wait, actually,
her eyes kind of go wide, and she looks away from you dramatically. Still, like with a hand on your chest.
You left her speechless.
And she looks up at you and she says, "I don't know if I'm ready to love yet. I've only known who I am again for the first time in so long." But I will wait for you here in Neverwinter.
So you will be staying here in Neverwinter?
I believe so. I need time to right myself, to learn how to be me again. I'll work at the temple, but free. Maybe I'll try and get other work too, but when you come back, when the call of the adventure is left, find me here. I'll be waiting.
Okay, and then I just want to quickly pull out that platinum ring that I found from the the red brand thing.
Yeah, a signet ring, okay.
Yeah, and I just want to say, like, keep this with you.
Mm-hmm.
And hold on to it for me, and whenever you look at it, you'll remember me.
She looks, she takes the ring, and she says, "Thank you, Droth." She pulls you in for a big wet one. And then, as she breaks off, she moonwalks away, goes back.
Moonwalks away.
All right, I need to leave the temple.
Okay, you leave. The rest of your boys are outside. The boys and Zathira are outside.
Did you tongue punch her uvula?
Yep.
He just straight up like. Full-blown man card, just like, yep, lies yep. about it.
Yep. Hey, he did tongue punch her uvula. They maxed out.
That's true.
Okay. And now that me and David have successfully flirted this much.
So I feel before we get to any more bright ideas, we should really consider selling the rest of these goblets.
Yeah, I also want to see if there's an alchemist in here, because I still have that dragon bile that's supposed to be good for potions, so...
I need an alchemist!
So we have a couple options. I'll be honest, I didn't know you guys were going to come to Neverwinter this soon, so I don't have a bunch of NPCs prepared, so I can make stuff up, that's fine. But if you guys want, we can just go through the stuff you guys want to sell, and we can just sell it now, because Neverwinter is huge, and I promise you there's someone in the city for everything you want to sell.
True, yeah.
Okay.
So we can just do that real quick and maybe wrap up a little early, and then next time you guys can tell me what you guys want to do, and then we'll figure it out.
Sure.
Because we've gone like 2.5 hours almost. So okay, so let's go one by one. Carlisle, what do you have that you want to sell?
I have the 3 goblets worth 60 GP. Okay. And I would also like to at least attempt to sell the red cloak that I have still on me.
Oh, that filthy thing? Okay.
Wait, don't you also have the amulet still?
I do. I do still have the amulet, actually. Right. Yeah.
Okay, so for the goblets, you can all get 40, because you're going to split the gold, I assume?
Yep.
Am I wrong? Okay, so, it's out of 5, not 4. Shoot.
It should be...
Unless Crust isn't here, so it can be out of 4. It's up to you guys.
Oh, boy.
Yes.
All right. So that's 45 gold for all of you guys.
Gotta pull up my calculator here.
He's not gonna know about this.
No, he won't know.
Trust me, he does not need your money. I want you all to guess, like...
I'm gonna say he has 1,200 gold.
1,200? Okay, maybe not that much. That's ridiculous.
Yeah, that's huge.
So we have 45 gold.
What about you? How much do you think he has, Drothka?
600.
Okay. What about you, Carlisle?
I will guess probably 800.
Do you want to guess, Yoshi? How much gold do you think Crust has?
Wait, what was that? What was your guess?
I said 800.
I'll do 951.
The correct answer, and you can't tell him that you know this, is 634.
Wow. Jeez. Wow.
He doesn't need your money. Okay. So you guys got 45 gold for the goblets. Are you selling the emerald as well, or are you holding on to that? The pendant?
I would like to attempt to sell the amulet.
Which is worth 200 gold, I believe.
Yeah.
Yes.
So that is... Oops.
Four.
That should be 200 by four. It's 50 gold each.
Nice.
Everybody gets 50 more gold.
We're moving up in the world, boys.
Mental math.
I have a calculator open.
No.
Drothgar.
I know which was.
Do you have anything you want to sell?
Yeah, I have three things that I want to sell.
Oh, sorry, Carlisle, was there anything else, or was that everything?
Oh,
that's everything. You know what, I think okay. I might hold on to the Red Cloak.
Okay, Drothgar.
Carnelian, which says 10 GP.
You can just take 10 GP and trade that in for one.
Alright.
Do you want to split it, or do you want to just... Because I think you guys split those stones.
Yeah, already. No, those stones we gave out evenly.
Yeah.
For
sure.
So I have a chalice that's worth 150 gold.
Okay. Do you want to sell that or split it with...
Well, they don't know about it.
Nope.
So,
nope.
Honestly, you know what?
Even if I did know about it, I wouldn't be offended if you kept it because you just spent 100 gold to cure yourself from a curse.
I'm going to...
But I mean, like, if you want to give some to your pals at theater who didn't hurt you with that zombie attack, just saying.
I'll slip Zathira 30 gold.
Okay. Aww, baby.
All right, anything else you want to sell?
Last is... says 3 diamonds for 100 gold.
Yeah, 3 diamonds worth 100 each, yeah.
Wow!
Yeah, 3 diamonds worth 100 gold each.
That's amazing.
You got those back in.
That's all damage. That was from.
Where did you?
King Grawl, wasn't it? That room.
It was. Yep.
I'm gonna sell them and keep it.
Okay, that's 300 gold.
I'm coming up on Crust's numbers now, baby.
Now that you've already sold them, I'll tell you, diamonds are super useful. As material components for spells,
yeah,
like if you ever get diamonds worth money, I highly suggest you keep them because diamonds are what you need to raise people from the dead.
Oh,
so if people die, awkward. you can spend diamonds to bring them back.
On that, what does a revivify scroll do?
So because it's a scroll, no material components are required. But if somebody dies within if you get to them within one round, I think it is, within 1 minute, so 6 rounds, you can cast it and bring them back to life. That's what the spell Revivify does. It's basically like a super defibrillator. It's like if they're fully dead, you can go kukunk, and then they're, I'm here, I'm back, hello.
Okay, because I have it, but I didn't have like a
description.
Like, yeah, a description of what it did.
Okay, Drothgar, is that everything you want to sell?
Yeah.
Okay, Zathira, do you have anything you want to sell?
Does anybody want to buy some human ears and dongs?
No, not a single person ever.
What about the head of a doppelganger?
Head of a doppelganger, yes. An alchemist will buy that.
Okay, and dragon bile?
Okay. For the two of those, you'll get 80 gold.
Ooh, 80 gold each or just for both?
Total.
Okay. Then I will get rid of them. So doppelganger head and where's the dragon bile? There it is. So 80 gold. Oh, hang on. Calculator. Seven, 8 plus 80. Ooh, I'm coming up on Mr. Hez here. Okay, is there anything else? Is anyone interested in perfume?
Yeah, you can find somebody to buy some perfume. What kind of perfume is it?
It just says perfume.
Where did you get it?
I think we found this in... Kragmaw Cave when we found the all the crates for the.
Oh yeah. Okay, yeah, you can sell that. It's not worth much though, like maybe 5 gold.
Okay, well then, I'm just gonna keep it.
Okay.
Make myself smell pretty.
Smell good. All right. Anybody else? Anything else, Zathira?
Not unless someone wants some ears and dongs.
Nope. Which are now turning to mush. They're not even.
Okay. I'll just drop those on the street.
Okay.
Wow.
All right. Yoshi, do you have anything you want to sell?
I got nothing.
All right. Because Crust is Crust, I'm going to say that he's going to sell the stuff he has without sharing with y'all. Just saying. That's fair, right?
Yep.
He's selling... He had 120 gold worth of art. He just sold.
Oh, yeah. Those art pieces. Yeah.
Wow.
And he has a decorative dagger. I don't know if he wants that, though. So I'm not going to sell that. Yeah. Cool. Let's see. That's a lot of art. Okay. So you guys spend the rest of the day in Neverwinter skipping through the shopping district, the market district, selling stuff and looking around. Is there anything anybody wants to buy? Like anything anybody's looking for?
Is there anyone here that sells like scrolls or magical items?
Go to a magic shop? Magic shop, sure. You take some time and eventually you find yourself outside of a building with a... It looks like a little gnome, a painting of a gnome pouring like a liquid into a vial of some kind with like a crazy look in his eye, and somebody tells you that's a magic shop. You step inside and you see this man. The gnome on the sign is behind a counter, and he's talking with somebody animated. And he's like, "Yes, yes, yes." And then once you use this, you'll be stronger forever. And then they kind of look at him and say. All right. And the guy walks out with a belt over his shoulder. And then he turns and looks at you and says, "Well, hello. What can I do for you all?"
"How you doing?"
I'm doing rather well, thanks. I just sold some stuff worth a lot of dollar bills, as they can say."
"Don't you mean golden coins?"
"Yes, golden. That's what I said. What can I do for you? Are you looking for anything exciting?"
"Yeah, I want to know what kind of exciting things you have."
"Well, we have a few things today. A few things. Let's see. I've got some. I mean, what are you looking for? Are you looking for like things?"
"Well, let me tell you what I do. Okay, so I'm an adventurer. We just came back from Thunder Tree. We almost killed a dragon." "You know, we get into some crazy things fairly often. What do you got that's like gear wise? Maybe some good scrolls, you know, things that could not just scare off a..."
"I've got
completely destroy the dragons.
I've got this," and she holds up a necklace, or holds up a necklace that looks like it's like a ruby in the shape of a heart. He says, "This will make you heartier if you spend the time to attune to it. It's very expensive, but if you get hit, you will be able to take a lot more. It's very, very powerful. It's lots of money too. Let's see. What else do we have? I've got these cool bags," and he holds up a little bag, and it's got a smiley face on it. It's a bag that looks like it has a smiley. Here, I'll show you a picture of it. That's not a very good description.
Oh,
I'm just picturing like the old 70s smiley face T-shirts, but on a bag.
It looks like this. I'll put it in Discord.
Tourist bag.
Looks like this.
Okay.
"This is a bag of holding. It will hold way more than you can carry. So, like, it's like a bottomless void of just throwing. So if you find yourself carrying way too much stuff, you can throw it in. Or if you, I assume you say you're an adventurer, I assume you have a group that you run around with. If you have a bunch of stuff you'd like to store as a group, you can just shove it in there and it's good to go. Bag of holding."
"Of holding, you say?"
"I've got these boots," and he holds up these boots, and he says, "These boots will let you move as if you are completely silent. Very sneaky.
Ooh.
This is very sneaky, sneaky.
I know someone who might like those.
I've got this belt, and he holds up a belt that's got, it's got like a, on the front of it, it's got like the picture of like a big, bulbous, strong face on it, and the belt is like green and leather, and he says, that'll make you really strong. It's really, really expensive, but it'll make you real strong. Let's see, I've got,
Wait, are all of us here, or is it just me?
It's up to you. Do you want to gather everyone, or did you want to just go on your own?
Well, two of these items are for other party members, for sure. So at least Carlisle and Drothgar, if they want to, they can be here.
Oh, sure. Yes, please.
I'm here.
We've got this.
And if Yoshi wants to, he can be here as well.
It's a brooch of shielding. While you're wearing this, force damage. Like damage from, you know, that spelled magic missile, it just won't hurt you. Like, it'll just poof, no magic missiles, and similar types of damage will be reduced significantly.
Just burps in your face.
Did you have too much to drink last night? Or...
Oh, I always do. It's really a problem. You know, I'm working it.
But at least you're self-aware about it. Not many people can say that.
It's true. I have this hat. And it's like a little, it looks like a baseball cap, like a blue baseball cap. He says, if you put that on and speak its command word, which is bubbly boop, this happens. And he puts it on his head and he says, bubbly boop. And out of the hat, like a glass, like fishbowl forms around his head. And he's like, and now,
and then I can breathe underwater.
And then he, bubbly boop. And then it goes back up and that's the baseball cap. And, and last, but certainly not least, we have this cloak, and he pulls out this big blue cloak with all these runic symbols written all across it. This cloak will make it harder for you to get hit, essentially. It's got a magical aura of protection around it. So yeah!
How much for the cloak?
Lots of dollar bills. Give me a hot minute. I have to double check. You're looking at approximately... Wait, this is not... This is not... Where is... Oh no, this is bad. Where... I scrolled... He's like looking at a ledger, this character.
Flipping through a book trying to find the pricing.
That cloak will run you about 400 gold pieces.
And how much for the necklace?
Which necklace was that?
The necklace of Hardy.
Oh, the necklace of Hardy. Oh, that one will run you approximately 3,200 gold pieces.
Carlisle just turns... Carlisle just kind of looks at Zathira. It's like... Too rich for my blood. Like, what's why you invite said, me?
You said the cloak was 300?
No, about 400 gold pieces.
Nice try, dude.
Would you take 300?
No.
Okay, listen. You're obviously a businessman, all right. I understand. You know, you're trying to make a couple dollar bills, as you say.
I do.
But you know, I'm an adventurer. You know, I go out there, I risk my lives, and I try to keep the place safe. We
I really don't care.
I know. I'm just
400 gold pieces.
You gotta be able to work with me a little bit. What's your absolute best price? We take 375.
Make a persuasion check.
Listen, you got a barter here, okay? Where's persuasion? Perception, performance, persuasion.
375. That's it. That's the lowest.
That's the lowest? Okay, I'll give you 375 for this cloak.
Save a whole 25 gold pieces.
All right, so you just got yourself a cloak of protection. So it will take one of your attunement slots. I don't know if you have any of those yet.
I'm attuned to the glass staff.
Yeah, so this one, what this does is it gives you a +1 to your AC. Just straight.
cloak of what? Protection?
Protection. Yeah, put it in your inventory and I can help you put it in as armor.
Yeah, it's in there.
Yeah, I can set it up as armor. Oh. Oh, you get a plus one bonus to your AC and saving throws.
Baby.
Nice.
That's really good. Let me just help you set that up.
I've only got 183 gold now, though.
Okay, while you guys do that, I'll BRB. If that's cool.
Yeah, that's fine. I'm going to... Global saving throw modifier, one. Let's try. Protection. You don't have.
Did the glass staff have any like modifiers on it, or was it just the
Oh no, it did. It gave you a plus one to your AC.
Ooh.
How do you have 15? Your AC should be 10 plus your dex.
Plus the glass staff plus.
So you should be at 12, unless.
And dragon resilience too, right?
Oh, dragon resilience, that's what it is. Yep, you're right. Yeah, so there you go.
So my armor class is 15 now.
And all your saving throws should be, yeah, they all have an additional one as well.
Ayy.
Yep. Is there anything else you'd like to buy?
Did he say if he had any like scrolls or anything like that, or is it just
he doesn't items? Have any scrolls, he just has items. Yeah. He says I can try and get scrolls, and the next time you're in we can make that happen.
Yeah, I might come back, you know. How much were those boots?
The boots, yes. The boots will run you about 350 gold pieces.
Okay, and what was the other thing he said? There was something else that was like...
The belt of strong?
Yeah, the belt of strong.
The belt of strong will run you about 5,000 gold pieces.
Yeah, no, I'm not going to get that.
Carlisle just kind of like, I have 152 gold. What made you think it was a good thing to invite me?
What if he'll take 152 gold?
No, I didn't say I wanted it.
You don't want boots of sneak?
How much are the boots of sneak?
300.
No, because I don't have 300 gold. I'm fine. I'm saving this for later. Thank you, though.
If you want the boots of sneak, I'll give you 100 gold and you can offer him 250.
I'm fine. I'm fine.
That long pause of, ooh.
Nah.
Yeah, I'm trying to be smart because I have alternate things for this money.
He smiles and he says, well, if that's everything you're going to buy, just tell your friends Jerome the Gnome sells the best mind.
Jerome the Gnome!
Oh, Jerome?
Yes.
Hold up. Jerome, that belt of strength or whatever?
5,000 gold pieces.
I'll give you 200.
That laugh that Zach's doing is the laugh he makes.
Jeez, you're...
200 and a kiss.
A fiery kiss. No.
No!
200 and a night with the cheeks.
Who has 5,000 gold pieces just laying around, buddy?
Rich people, which you clearly aren't.
Where's Crust when you need him?
I may not be rich, but I'm dangerous, so don't mess with me, bub.
So am I. Would you like to see?
Genuine question.
Yes, of course.
Where did you acquire the belt? Where do you get most of your items?
Mostly adventurers like you selling it to me.
Hmm. Do you remember the adventurer that sold you the belt? Did he tell you a story about it?
Oh my goodness, no. I buy most of my things anonymously or get them at auctions, to be
What level was he?
You see a nose bleed? Like, his nose just starts bleeding? I don't know what to mean.
We've broken the game.
Yeah. What adventure was he on?
How many hit points did he have?
Yeah. Do you remember what his armor class was?
His head just caves in, the world
falls apart.
What
player module was the DM reading from?
What was his race and class, and do you know exactly how many constitution points did he have?
And how many languages they spoke?
So he says, Jerome the Magic Gnome, don't forget about me, okay?
He's just broken now in the infinite loop of Jerome the Magic Gnome.
Okay, bye.
And with that, as you guys head out into the street, I'm assuming you guys are going to find a place to stay the night, like an inn or something.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, so... Yeah.
I don't know why Drothgar didn't invite Mary Lou to the inn, but...
Do you want an expensive inn, or like a fancy expensive inn, or do you want like a regular boring old...
Now, how expensive are we talking?
Oh, man, if you want to go with the fanciest inn, it's like 5 gold a night.
I would
like to.
Can we like party hardy?
Might I make another suggestion and not spend so much gold? I mean, we just killed a dragon. Sure, yes, we're invincible. Rah, but money.
But we just killed the dragon, and we
but
need to live
I,
it.
I will not.
5 gold.
I refuse to adhere to.
I'll pay
your
for your
mindset.
Hotel room.
Okay.
All right, so you guys go and you find an amazingly fancy hotel. We find
the best hotel there is in Neverwinter.
It's got a complimentary breakfast. It's one of those places where like you pay, and then once you pay, it's like a resort type thing. Like once you pay, the drinks are free. And and the music is oddly familiar. There's some guy playing retro bagpipes. No, that's not true. That doesn't happen. but the night is spent well. It's a nice night.
Do we get free people that come join us in our beds?
No. What? Oh gosh, no.
No.
What? For 5 gold? Like what the heck, man? Do I get like a free massage?
You can get a massage.
Does it give us like a temporary boost to our stats for the next day? Like, are we well rested?
Tony is the biggest metagamer I've had.
I know. I have questions.
Can I have someone bathe me like The Witcher?
Yeah, somebody bathes you, sure.
Oh,
you
sweet.
Bad. Do I get every Red Dead Redemption crack too. And crevice?
I mean, no. But as we'll kind of fade out on you guys living it up and getting yourselves cleaned up and resting in a real bed for the first time in who knows how long you guys have been out and about, out in a boot. But with that, I think as you guys get your rest and take your long rest and get back up to full, that is where we will end the session.
Craig, was
that was fun, guys.
Craig, was
up next time.
That was good.
Craig, was that a Doctor Who reference?
No.
Oh.
That was a Canadian.
Okay, now I have to level my person up with spells. So.
Yeah, you get one new cantrip, and you get another new spell that you can put in first level or second level.
We shall see.
You will try.
I'm gonna have to look up a bunch of these spells. That's for sure.
I need to find a power adapter that works with my SL2 because I recently got a new camera and a cam link to use my DSLR as a webcam.
Ooh.
And I realized that the battery is just not long enough for my live stream, so I'm looking for a faux battery, which is actually like a power adapter.
Right.
And not a lot of them exist.
True Strike is interesting. It lets me see what the target's defense is.
Well, it gives you advantage on next attack. The problem is that it takes your action to use. It's actually not a good spell.
Oh, so like I can't. Okay, that's stupid. Screw you then.
There was a lot of really bad trips.
Shocking Grasp.
You have so many damaging cantrips. You don't need any.
I'm just looking.
Prestidigitation.
But what is prestidigitation? Like, I was reading it, and...
It's like a fancy thing. It's just, I can do this thing. Or dancing lights is super good, too, if you want to be able to light places up. But prestidigitation is like, I clean myself off. Just, it's done. Like, at will. Not in combat. Like, just do it whenever. Or, I light all the candles in the room. And it's done. Like, it's awesome. It's just dope stuff like that.
You chill, warm, or flavor up to one cubic foot of non-living material. I want to make that chair taste like strawberries. I can clean or soil an object. Can I soil someone's pants?
Yeah, literally just go, boom, you have dirty clothes. Boom! I have clean clothes.
Yeah. See, Carlisle's a bit of like, he kind of prides himself of being a performer of sorts, and so he has prestidigitation to really wow the crowd.
Yeah.
What's dancing lights?
Dancing lights. You make four little lights that light up rooms. It's very good. Or you can squish them all together and they make a glowing man.
Ooh.
It's really useful for dark places when you don't have dark vision. Most of you guys don't. Anyway, guys, I'm going to hop off because I'm a sleepy beepy. But really fun, guys.
Yeah, it was.
I'm glad, David. David, I'm glad you found love in a hopeless place.
At least D&D worked out.
Oh, gosh. No.
Oh, I'm not. What am I doing wrong here?
Oh no, that's so sad, David. There's plenty of fish in the sea.
David, you'll find a woman.